It's better than a poke in the eye with a sharp stick.
Thanks, man.
Ritual of tickling.
Crushing evil.
Yeah. With a blank.
Pants disappearing.
So this conversation is our characters are hitting the end of their freshman year and they're leveling up.
level four.
End of the first semester.
You're gonna have finals after this.
I
never took a test yet. Oh boy. We gotta roll.
You gotta roll.
Your
journalism. If you roll really, really well.
Doesn't matter.
One of the really good ones is you get a free skill. And the skill comes in at like level D6 or something.
So me? I was never good at math. English.
Bob, you want to light up behind there? You were off, but.
I'm good. Sorry. I'm fine. Thank
you. I was
guys.
Good.
All right, so Jeff, you're going to play a ritual. Do you know what you're doing?
Yeah.
For Johnny.
Do you want the manual for the list of rituals? Is that
helpful? Yeah, that would be helpful.
But Johnny Moon, with his Indian background or Native American background, he's thinking definitely he's going to know how to do a ritual. That's cool.
I'll give you the depending on when you want. You're supposed to learn how to do the ritual.
Hmm.
If it's Native American based, I will allow your grandmother to teach it to you.
Ooh.
So I'll give it to you.
Of course, we have no idea how you're getting the heck out there.
Dude, it's genetic.
Maybe you know? She already.
You're going to go into a trance and you're going to spirit walk.
And what are you going to do, Mr. Or? One low.
I've been working out with the martial arts club.
Better look at this.
Buffing my agility.
Oh, you're back
nice
again,
and
pretty pretty. Hi. Pretty pretty. Hi. Where's that other key? Shh, don't tell your
inner. Bob is looking. He's deciding. Chris is.
I'm deciding as well.
And Mikey will be joining us shortly.
Oh, you're so cute.
Amy's back from her Girl Scout meeting. It's really exciting.
I'm never going to
sign
up for something.
Sucker!
Here you go, Bob. I just have to color the rainbow.
Holy moly, look at that.
The unicorn that barks a rainbow.
That's fantastic.
In Bart and Rainbow, too?
No,
it's
his
tail.
Okay. I think the original team name with the picture of the unicorn barfing the rainbow was going to be Taste the Rainbow.
Yeah.
But I think the team name
was Rainbow.
The name was already taken, so Andrew and I decided we still had to get the unicorn in here.
Amy, I can't believe your drawing skills are excellent. That is really, really good.
You just put the picture underneath the...
Her tracing skills are excellent.
You didn't have to tell me that. You totally didn't have to tell me that. I would have just believed.
Kitty, kitty.
Oh, very impressive
porn,
stuff.
Huh?
All right. That's pretty awesome. All right.
So, once I color them in, I'll...
So, are we still wearing tutus?
You got some stuff in our hair.
Well, Jules and I found hot pink feather bows that we were thinking of sewing around the base of your guy's shirt.
Yeah, here, take this.
All right, cool.
So
this one then is to try and embarrass you. The thing in your life, is that the purpose of this?
It's kind of like payback for the Mutter and Dragon shirt she wore for a day.
Mm. But the thing is, I had to wear that Mutter and Dragon shirt for the day, too.
Yeah, but you were proud
but
of it.
I was not proud of that. I was just hoping people wouldn't look.
They wouldn't put it together. I think that's the
Bob
and so what are you
going
to find, like, the darkest chalk to run up to and just...
Hit me! Hit me! I mean, don't hit me!
He's going to grow a beard.
No, there you
He's
go.
He's not going to shave for a week.
Nobody will recognize me.
Grow, just a goatee, you can be like the master.
It's perfect. Yes, with a soul patch.
Goatee and you can be evil Bob.
Not bad. I haven't done that. I mean, he hasn't done that.
Oh, your boyfriend.
We haven't seen evil Bob. We've never seen evil Bob.
You never seen me with a goatee?
No.
Oh. I thought we did.
I think you may have. It's been 8 years, right? Surely I must have come in once.
Adam?
Come on,
watch out, Paul.
Yeah.
Has Bob ever come with Evil Bob with the goatee?
No.
Wow. So when you guys do this, I don't know if this is just me, you get 2 weeks, maybe you're on vacation or something, so you decide not to shave. So you have like the beginnings of a pretty good beard. Then
nope.
No.
Are you talking about those two?
No, sorry. I guess I'm working.
Chris and I can relate.
Wait, yeah. What? I'm all the time coming in strong.
It's
anyway.
When hair comes out of your
neck. You know how when your neck gets fuzzy?
I'll tell you.
Yeah. Well, I'm sure you get to that point.
He gets to that point all over his face.
Maybe not in 2 weeks. Maybe.
Jeff gets the neck scruff, but not the actual beard.
3 months.
However long it takes, eventually you have this. You go to the mirror in the bathroom, and now it's time to get rid of it. Do you ever experiment when you're getting rid of it to try different like facial patterns?
I did the handlebars. I did the where it comes down all the way down one dive.
Yeah, you had that for one of our things.
I think I saved it for, I gave it for like 3 or 4 days and you hated it.
This guy used to work with me, used to be my boss.
The mustache.
Oh, God. Oh, God.
Before Josh used to work there.
Yeah.
This guy would go on long weekends for a ski trip and come out with like a freaking full beard. And then over the course of the next few weeks, he shaved parts of it off.
Who is this?
Like Baba Stone. It was before you got there. Like, he would go with, like, the goatee and mutton chops. And then he'd shave the mutton chops just into, like, sideburns. And then shave the goatee down to a mustache and sideburns.
Yeah,
it was like every week got progressively less. Like, the guy was like, nut. And he was horrible at his job.
One day Hitler walks in. You're like, no, 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 no.
Michael Jordan. He was his Michael Jordan mustache.
Michael Jordan was
the
Josh, I think we're going to take knowledge.
Knowledge of what?
Oh.
Knowledge ritual.
This handy spell provides the target with a new skill he does not currently have as die type equal to its linked attribute and one additional die type with a race.
Uh-huh. Who's going to teach you that ritual?
Glenn Mac or your grandmother in the spirit
world. Rams.
So wait, what does knowledge do? One more time.
Sure. Oh, your ritual is knowledge.
The ritual is knowledge.
So you've been smoking. So you got.
So this is the ritual you want at finals time.
Yeah.
That is actually what it says here.
What does it do?
This is an especially popular ritual around exam time.
It so read the bomb again, so he can figure out how to abuse it.
This handy spell provides the target with a new skill he does not currently have a die type equal to its linked attribute.
Wow.
Oh, wow. So if you have like a D10 strength, you could get like
D10 fighting.
A new skill. D10 agility if you didn't have it. Yeah. Or like, you know, your D10 smarts, you could suddenly have D10 knowledge.
If you had D10 agility, you'd have D10 shooting.
Yes.
Yeah. But if you don't have any shooting.
If you don't, you cannot have the skill.
That's it. Do you have shooting already? Of course you do. You live in Texas. Do you have fighting? Yes, of course you do. You live in Texas.
But a target doesn't have to be me.
That's true.
This is like the warlordy skill.
That is really interesting.
I make everybody better.
What's the duration?
Okay.
3 rounds.
Ooh. Interesting.
So it's really good for exam time. You do the ritual. By the time you get to class, it's over.
You got to do the ritual outside of class.
And then you walk in and sit down, and it's over.
Wait, how long is 3 rounds? That's like
18 seconds.
18 seconds, 6 times 3, I guess.
Yeah.
So.
I had to double check the round time. That's D&D time. I don't know.
I thought it was the same. I look it up, but I'm lazy.
No, D&D is segment is 6 seconds.
AD&D or 40?
Oh, what am I thinking? This is the manual that has no page numbers. But I can still see if round is in there.
I had a page number on it. Tell the page number.
Sure, sure.
See if you find another ritual that would be.
Round is not in there.
Why am I doing your job?
Maybe time.
It's your character, not mine.
Well, you also have to find that for a novice.
Time. Page 64.
Curse.
Curse was the other one.
It's just I happened to look at it and it said novice.
Is there increase? Oh, that's one of those powers from Deadlands. Increase. Trait, lower trait.
There's curse.
Attribute, lower attribute.
Which I can curse somebody.
A sinking feeling, a moment of nausea. Curses are by far the most common black magic in use.
I will not let you take black magic at this point. Because bad things happen to you if you use black magic.
So your choices are more knowledge.
10 rounds, then it's 6 minutes.
Oh, 6 minutes isn't bad.
It's 1 minute. I'm sorry, it's 1 minute.
3 rounds.
Game time breaks down into rounds of 6 seconds each.
Yeah. So, 3 rounds is 18 seconds.
You're going to be faster than that test.
Well, actually, I guess that's true. 18 seconds.
Oh, there's a black magic corruption table? That's awesome.
Enough to use
hey,
one skill
right
twice, maybe, or 3 times tops. Oh, 3 rounds, 3 uses, right?
Hey, you're not supposed to read that part.
One per round.
He wanted to look and see if there's a better ritual.
3 rounds, one per round.
I agree.
You can take any spell as a ritual. It's a matter of...
The ritual is 3 rounds, one per round.
So D6,
okay.
D8,
that's
D2 uses.
So you can do it 3 times.
Your choice is fish.
Investigate is smarts, I think.
Alright, so you
can
fish
spend
or
one and get it to a D6.
If you want to take a ritual, you can take a ritual for any spell.
D8, you'd have to spend two.
But there's no spells there because there's no arcane magic.
But that's you can convert any arcane magic spell with a reason to a ritual.
Obviously, you wouldn't want to convert bolt into a ritual.
Like, agility goes to shoot? Oh, you don't have shooting.
But, yeah, but I'm
trying
to go for...
The fireball-y, multi spell?
Gotcha.
I mean, you could, but
the,
really...
One of the investigator ones?
Hold on a second. Give me, like, 10 minutes and we're taking
this time. No, that's not...
I know what you mean. I know. I'm trying to, like...
You can prepare it ahead of time. And then invoke it.
On the right page.
That's how I read it. I should give it to you to read.
You told me not to. You just told me not to.
Yeah, I know why. I need somebody else who knows how to read rules.
No,
he's just going to twist it all over the place.
He does sometimes do creative interpretation.
I already got my smarts at D8.
That's a nice way to put
it. No, smarts at D6. Spirits at D8.
Okay. So you got a...
I got to go my smarts at D8.
Why is she going first?
Lola!
That's not a bad way to do it.
Right, and then these I can put in my pot.
Yeah, in fact, it's good to pump up your smarts because you're only allowed to increase your attribute cost per tier.
Oh, good.
And we're about to leave that tier.
No, we better get it up then.
So okay, well,
that's a good choice.
Put his face
very
in.
Very good choice.
Face
get smarter.
Yeah.
What was she just into?
The garbage can.
Oh.
Actually, it's better when she chews on the carpet padding.
There you go.
Yeah. And then the other day, Liz was going to bed. She goes, "What's all over the carpet here? There's all these little beads." She got into the little silica gel packet.
Oh.
Pour open and beads and.
Does she
realize?
She's going
to die. Well, nice solid
yes, eventually.
Yeah, nice solid. Very dry.
Yeah. So I think Chris and I are good on
she walk around like this all day?
Okay, so we're waiting to hear for Mikey to join us.
Oh, we can still do
does
the
she not realize she's not a dog?
What we're doing.
Uh-huh.
Sure.
So Ford Prefect, the journalist.
Thank you. Thank
what
you
do
very
you
much.
Do?
I have learned so much so far being with these guys and done a lot of research in this weird, wild stuff. He's seemed smarter than he was at the beginning of his freshman year.
Oh, so you actually studied a little.
A smidgen.
So that's what you were doing the whole time when you weren't hanging out with us in the beginning of the
I
year?
I was studying, again, Braille by anatomy.
Anatomy?
Braille by Braille.
Ah, okay.
All right, so you went and took a level of
I'm familiar with that course. Not that I practice it very much, but I've heard of it.
So your smarts went from a D what?
6 to 8.
Ooh.
Just like my chip.
Oh, you're so smart.
And Edison?
I think I might change one thing. I am going to increase 2 skills. Edison has improved his ability to repair things from a D6 to a D8, which is int-based.
You have D8 smarts?
I have a D10 smarts.
Whoa!
That's the price I pay for D4 and everything else.
He's how do you like them apple smart?
Yeah. Except Matt Damon also is born from the Bourne identity, so like he didn't have a D4
strength or agility.
Or agility.
He had a D10 everything.
He's also going to be the Martian.
Yeah.
He's the best botanist on that planet.
That's true.
If you see the trailer, he's the best botanist on the planet.
That is true. I'm looking forward to that. So that's one point invested to increase that. So the other point is either going to be increasing mechanical engineering or computer science. What do you guys think is more useful to the group?
Mechanical engineering or what?
Or not useful.
What are your other skills?
Other skills? I've got a D4 healing, which I could increase. That's smarts related. Does anybody have a D6 healing at this point?
Nobody wants to heal nothing.
I don't heal people. I make things get hurt.
He's got a D4 lock picking. He's got a D4...
Lock picking would be good.
Taunt. He's got a D8 taunt. Wow, I never used that.
You're ugly.
And he's got a D6 notice. He can increase notice. And he's got... Oh,
Mike, he has like a D8000 notice.
I got a D6 plus 2 notice.
Streetwise.
He's got 1 point in fighting and 1 point in shooting.
It probably wouldn't hurt to increase your test-taking skills, your exam skills.
Because it's going to get harder as the years
go. It's going to get harder as the years go.
What's your test-taking skills?
That's true. Your knowledge of journalism.
Oh, good.
I think every year it's a minus 1 to each roll.
Yeah.
Nice.
Okay, so it's going to be either computer science or mechanical engineering. Actually, maybe I'll skip on repair. Maybe repair is not necessary. Maybe I'll just increase the knowledge skills since I'm a double major.
I hate this. That's such a waste of a...
I know.
Mechanical engineering and computer engineering?
I know.
Both of those could potentially be useful.
Yeah, but at the same time...
I mean, I architecture for crying out loud.
I could make the point that you take your final exam, and if you do pass, your skill level goes up 1. To represent your gain
in knowledge. I wouldn't argue with that.
But then
but your knowledge has to go up, but the difficulty goes up as well. So they go up in lockstep.
I think you're right. I think I gotta put points into mechanical engineering and computer science so that
I think it'll be good for sophomore year at that point.
Maybe at D8. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, so that's what I'll do.
Your roll is at a -2, right?
Hmm.
You roll those at a -2 and take the best of each one.
Because he took test taker as an edge, the minus is negated. So he rolls without a minus.
Oh, nice. Thanks for telling me all this before I picked that up.
What? What's your...
Hey, you could have read the rules.
You didn't ask. Yeah, I was going to say.
You can increase journalism if you want.
It's already done. I've already done it. It's already written.
He erased.
Oh, you changed it up.
No, it's my smart.
Well, your journalism went from a 6 to an 8.
No, but
journalism was a 6. You wouldn't have been able... No, you would have been able to.
I want to clarify. If you just bumped your smarts, that counts as your expenditure.
But now, next time you can bump that, you can bump your journalism because it's tied to your smarts.
Yeah, it'll be
D8. And something else.
All right. So you can bump a trait, which is strength and whatever.
Mm-hmm.
You can add a skill, or you can increase two skills to right now.
As long as they are no higher than your linked attribute.
Or take an edge.
Yeah, one edge.
Oh, hey.
Juan Lo?
You don't look like the other thing.
Juan Lo bumped his agility.
Six to eight, not
bad.
Yeah. Has he been watching a lot of American Ninja Warrior?
He's been doing it at the martial arts club.
Oh, get into that, don't you?
There's an American Ninja Warrior club.
Oh.
Oh.
There's a 3-hour American Ninja Warrior thing coming up.
Tonight.
Yeah.
Finals.
Is there a girl in it?
I watched a little bit of it.
No, she's out.
Oh,
none of the girls finished the warp wall in the fall.
We watched the first girl, and then we haven't seen the episode
since. Really amazing hot chick? The gymnast chick?
Casey Cannizzaro.
That's her.
She failed.
Did she?
She did
the warp wall the first one.
Yeah, but no, she didn't get that far. My kids would tell you. I don't know exactly.
The second obstacle, if you were too light, you couldn't do it.
Oh, that's her.
Because you had to jump off of a...
she missed the tramp. She missed
a trampoline to power up to a propeller that was up there.
Oh.
And anybody who was short or light and didn't get explosiveness out of it, just had their hands on and fell off.
Yeah,
the people who caught under here were fine.
So there was
two girls who got past that because they were a little bit bigger.
Right.
And, she
but
was
the
gymnast,
got,
too, though.
Yeah, but the warp wall,
it's like
when you have Vegas, is shorter and a taller. The run-up is shorter and the height is taller, I think. So they just didn't have the gumption to get up.
But she did that pole thing. Did you see that?
Oh, last season.
There was a girl on the pole.
Yeah, when she there was like a 6-foot gap and she was like 5 foot. And she had to actually jump like a monkey to the next pole.
Yep.
Oh,
that was,
I think you guys
that was cool.
My kids were going nuts.
That was awesome.
They love the
hi. You welcome back. Don't lick your crotch.
It's not my crotch, it's my ass.
Oh, is it?
So everybody's leveled up in the room. Johnny Moon, you're going for the education ritual? A knowledge ritual?
I think so.
How long does it take for you to cast that, though?
I can prep it.
Okay.
And have it ready to go.
And that's knowledge of a skill, right?
I would hold that you have the right components to prep that.
Yep.
Like if you wanted to learn mechanical engineering,
yeah.
I would certainly have a mechanical engineering book be one of the components that's used up.
Oh, that's reasonable.
Along with whatever else we decide to use.
So this is interesting. Can you use the knowledge?
I have no idea how to use these.
I'm just trying to think of how we could employ this to our benefit. You could use knowledge ritual to instill the knowledge of rituals to somebody else.
It would have to have a book with all the rituals in it.
He could write down the ritual of knowledge and then use
that's
that as
true.
His component, right?
Yeah, then he wouldn't know rituals. He wouldn't know how they worked. He would know the mechanics of them.
Isn't knowledge ritual a knowledge skill? Doesn't that, or is that an edge? What is rituals? Isn't that knowledge based?
Read the section. There's not much to it.
Oh, here's another thing you can figure out for exams. If you dual major, do you roll twice on the table, or do you roll once and take the best result of the two? I didn't have time to look it up.
I don't remember.
I think on the table you only roll once. Your pass-fail is where you roll twice.
Okay.
I didn't look up that stuff today. So.
It seems like if that's true, then the edge for being a dual major is not that useful at all.
I don't remember now.
All right, so it's been 20 minutes. We gotta wait for Mikey still. A few more.
I'll get until quarter after.
Except that clock's off. That's fine.
Mm-hmm.
It is a quarter after.
It's 16 after.
By that clock.
We'll give him a few more minutes. What?
Sure.
9:20, 9:21.
Sure.
All right.
Who's Adrienne Barbeau? Do you know?
Yeah, Adrienne Barbeau.
Adrienne Barbeau was the girl in Escape from New York.
That was impressive.
Vernon Wells.
I just remember Ernest Borgnine was the taxi driver.
Amen. How about Vernon Wells?
And his taxi went all of like 15 miles an hour.
Road Warrior Commando.
Where were they getting fuel to run the taxi? Brand was manufacturing it and giving it to Cabby?
I saw that movie when I was all of... I was old enough.
That's a classic, dude. You could watch that 100 times.
I have to be on HBO one day.
It does, man.
What's the next big movie that you are waiting for to come out?
Star Wars.
Is there anything else coming before Star Wars?
The Martian.
Here's one of my buddies at school.
Then Star Wars.
Oh, no.
That is awesome.
Vacation.
He built that?
Did he make that?
No. It's that Scarathon.
Oh, my goodness.
That's pretty
cool. I missed it.
Scroll up for the other pictures of people he is with.
He's stepping out of a TARDIS up. Yeah, I'm scrolling up. Wow. Yep.
So yeah, Star Wars.
David Scott.
Oh, what did we go see? Oh, we went to go see Ant-Man. There was the preview for the trailer for Star Wars, and it was this long, wide shot of Tatooine going.
Ghost Hunter. Rose Warrior.
And I look in the background is a Star Destroyer like crashed on Tatooine. I was like,
she went above. She was in Swamp Thing in the movie.
Yes,
she was. A romantic interest.
Yes, she was.
She was in Carnival on HBO.
She was a fun thing. She was his girlfriend.
Hairs on the back of my neck started standing up, and the tears started welling up in my eyes.
Wow, that's pretty cool.
Blown away.
Your friend's got connections.
In low places.
All right, just invite Mikey. Let's see if he finds it.
Give him one more minute.
He's signed me. He said he's ready now. Sorry.
Did he say resend the link?
He said sorry, ready now, and I said no problem. Invite sent. And he still hasn't jumped.
By the way, Adam, I was telling Josh, the makers of the original 1987 Wasteland RPG made a sequel called Wasteland 2.
There he is.
Which is the grandfather of the Fallout series.
Oh, yes. Okay.
And Wasteland 2, highly recommended.
He's all tanned up in Florida.
Look up, buddy. He's traveled today. Where are you today? You're muted.
Buffalo, was our call.
You're muted.
I'm going to say Buffalo, New York. Muted. Because I took the psychic...
I can't hear you.
You're muted.
There's a mute icon on your screen, dude. It looks like you're muted in Hangouts.
Yeah, it looks like your Hangouts might have a mute button.
Can't hear you.
That
means muted in death.
He's broken. He's sitting extremely still right now.
Saw him on a ninja Saturday night.
He just rolled a 20.
Couldn't touch any of it, but I saw it.
One of these days, I just want to see someone run behind him.
Not Starling. You know what? Next time we have a game night, I'm going to tell Starling to sneak up behind him and scare
him. Sure.
That would be great.
I always jokingly said, when I moved home after failing out of my first college, you might remember my old house. There was a room over the garage.
I do.
And I had the back corner of that room where I had my stuff set up. And it's like 10:30 at night. I'm playing, it's pitch black, I'm playing Doom. And all I'm thinking to myself, you know, I've been there for like 4 hours. All I'm thinking to myself is, if my father even walks up and puts his hand on my shoulders, I'm going through the roof. Leaving a pile of stinks.
He must have ran away, like there.
I guess so. He didn't like us.
Come back, Michael.
There he is.
You're still muted, though.
He looks intent, though, huh?
He's reading.
So, Mike, can you hear us? Yeah. Nod your head if you can hear us, buddy.
Oh, yeah.
So we can't hear you yet.
And you know...
I know what you just said, though.
He's got to go into the Hangouts and switch his audio.
He knows.
That's what he said?
I see him nodding. I think he knows what he needs to do.
I think he said friends.
Or FU.
But he might have said FU.
That's it's ETU.
ETU. Oh, slow down, you're burning out that keyboard.
It's not even fast.
You use more than two fingers, like, wow. One, that's great.
I'm so happy I took typing with Dumpy.
I took Dumkowski, really? I took it with Nekio?
Nekio? Oh, Nekio was my homeroom teacher.
We used did you guys use the Smith yeah. Brothers word processor?
No, we used typewriters.
Typewriter. I used the word processor.
Oh, my God.
When I took typing, it was not a typewriter.
When I was in when I was in high school, we were doing, you know, computer science, which was copying basic programs out of a book. But it was computers.
Yeah.
So all we did was goof around in class all day, find the one kid who actually did the work and copied his program.
Why does everybody have the same program? I don't know.
Because we all copied it from the same book. Although, you know, the header was supposed to be, you know, you put your name here and blah, blah, blah. There were some kids who forgot to change their name. Like, you idiots. Even I knew to change the damn name.
And I was high.
Might have been. No, not in school. Never in school.
Just every waking moment outside of it.
Well, I worked at McDonald's. Anybody out there who's worked at McDonald's knows exactly what I'm talking about.
His name is Adam.
So that's a statute of limitations on that?
Can't prove anything.
We were talking about earlier, because Fear the Walking Dead is halfway through the season now, how useless having a barber is in your group from a survival perspective, which led us to what is the least useful profession have in the zombie apocalypse?
I said
Computer administrator?
Fry daddy. McDonald's fry manager.
Maybe. Although, I don't know. I mean, you learn to put together some pretty good items when you're working in the grill back there. I mean, you know, just like tomatoes and cheese, chicken nuggets and mustard.
Deep fry anything.
Great.
They're deep fry master.
I can remember Jeff telling the story when his girlfriend worked at McDonald's and Jeff would eat there. How many did she fit in the 9-pack?
She would fit like 22 nuggets in a 9-piece box.
Oh, wow. I never, so, I was never, the 9 would probably be like.
And then she'd 18? Give him, then she'd give him the ice cream cup to put his sauce in.
Oh, you'd have little tubs of sauce? You'd have the squirter thingies? No. So, yeah, we never had those in our lobby. Our dining room.
They couldn't trust you guys.
I lived in Seymour, dude. No, they couldn't trust us. When I worked there, if you search all of our pockets and took all of our dimes and nicks and put them all on the counter, you have at least an 8. I'm just on any given day. Like, yeah, I'm going out for my half-hour break.
So we have a guy at work who has one of those little smoker thingy.
Yeah.
The e-cig or vapor, whatever it is.
The vapor things. And nobody gives him a hard time because nobody smells it. Mm-hmm. I guess the new thing now is to put
flavor
marijuana oil in it.
Oh, nice. But I heard that's super, super expensive.
But it's super, super concentrated, so it doesn't take much.
I got marshmallow one. My brother-in-law's
got... Any questions?
Hey, Michael!
Hey!
We heard you for a second, buddy. Then he stopped.
All right, that sounds good.
Ooh, that's crystal. Whoa,
that is crystal clear. Wow.
Yeah,
it's this newfangled headset I have.
It looks fancy.
That sound quality is fantastic.
We actually have to turn him down.
Is it a headset?
Which one is it?
You sound better than Chris Jones does right now.
Well, really.
Chris is here.
The speaker is the Jabra.
Chris Jones in the house.
In the house. What up?
It doesn't sound like it.
No, okay, then you just down that one.
Yeah, it's this really fancy schmancy headset thing I bought.
That's good.
That also allows you to make phone calls.
Nice. Oh.
It's fancy tech, it's Mikey.
Yeah, it better be for like $125 for freaking.
That's the difference. We would love to have something like that, but we just can't afford it.
But you know what? He used the other ones for a long time.
I did. The other ones weren't bad, but these are really nice. Some black guy made them.
Gotta be good.
Mike, where are you this week?
I am in the wonderful city of Buffalo.
Oh. So did you know that Buffalo, 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 Buffalo?
Yes.
It's a legitimate sentence.
I am in the house of wings.
Nice.
So you're closer to us now than you usually are. Mileage.
Yes, I am definitely. Yes, I'm definitely.
That's
true.
He's only about 6 or 7 hours drive from us.
Hey, are you going to be in Connecticut in October or no?
I'm not sure yet. I might actually have to have surgery in October.
Gallstone.
Also surgery. Also yes.
Oh wow.
Old now.
So there's this extra organ that I don't need. That hopefully they'll take out and
but I dude, you're not married.
I was going to say, you're not from Starland?
So, all right, so you got to level up.
All right, what do I get?
You can raise a trait, you can add a skill, or you can raise 2 skills, or take an edge. Why don't we recap what everybody did really quick for Mikey?
Sure.
I increase marks.
Yeah.
That was quick.
Chris up smarts.
Well, that first character. Wait, Chris's smarts or his characters?
I did both.
Come on.
I did both.
That's Ford Prefect, the newspaper reporter for the school.
Smart guy.
That's right.
Yeah. And Edison is already smart enough, so he got better in his studies of mechanical engineering and computer science.
So he can get smart.
He's got a D8 in both. Yeah.
Nice.
Juan Lowe's been spending some extra time at the
dojo
martial arts club, and so his agility increased.
Wax on, wax off.
Roger that.
Mooney?
I took the ritual.
Ritual.
Skill. Where I can
do ritual.
Do
a ritual.
Skill. I took the ability to do the knowledge ritual, which allows me to grant myself or somebody else an untrained ability. A couple turns.
Okay.
For 18 seconds.
And so I get to choose now.
Is your psychic sensitivity supposed to be, you're supposed to take that now, did we say? Or was that something else?
Oh, I don't know. Is that, I don't remember how we said we were going to work that. I think you might be right.
Hey, the GM knows something.
Oh, I mean, we can work it however you want, Joshy. I'm good.
Let's go with that if you're all right with that.
Yeah, I'm totally good with that.
Okay. So, we are back now for
just
session.
Fast and easy, and we can get started.
Evil
Ravens?
Evil Raven?
Ravens. Mm-hmm. And actually, if you go to fightingravens.com.
Really?
Yeah, I actually use it for resources. There's actually faculty lists and everything there.
And by the way, what does psychic sensitivity do for Joe Diffie?
Yeah.
Makes him tingly and special part.
It gives him the ability to commune at some level with spirits.
Got it. Okay.
So you guys have an easy book over there somewhere. So yeah.
Which makes sense since Joe is always in an altered state of mind.
His third eye is open.
Yeah. Ooh. But he's usually on top of his pants up, though.
Here's another question. For your ritual, where now if you want to give somebody the power of mechanical engineering, you have to sacrifice a book on a mechanical engineering. What if you download a PDF?
Or a page, maybe?
What if you download a PDF and put it on a jump drive and then just sacrifice the jump drive?
Magic doesn't understand that. You have to print it out.
Magic doesn't understand. But printing out is actually...
Technology doesn't work.
It's the same technology. Printing is...
I just hit delete.
Hit delete, yeah. But seriously, if you think about it, crushing wood to turn it into pulp to create pages.
No, you don't have to destroy the book. You put the book there and it's consumed as part of the process.
Duh, everybody knows that.
Okay, but it just seems to me like recording electronic onto a jump drive is actually no different than a book when you think about it.
You need some touch.
Okay,
pads.
Yes, but Magic sees a book as compressed paper with letters on it,
mm-hmm.
and it sees the jump drive as a large collection of positive and negative charges. Actually, I think it's positive charges and no charges.
I think it's very curious that Magic is sort of like my grandfather, caught in time, unable to progress past
1950. Okay, can Magic read machine language?
Yes.
Sure, if you wrote a ritual for it, why not? Magic.
If Jeff understood it, if he understood it, maybe.
Oh, that's good. Yeah. That's interesting.
Okay, arrow dodge, moving on.
Well, Bob was speaking, so...
All right. So it is the week before finals, so classes are pretty much over. Some of you are studying. Some of you should be studying.
I can't talk to any of you right now. I need to study.
Joker's staying.
Yeah.
I've made a timeline here. You can see I've highlighted in orange the times where I'll be studying mechanical engineering. I've highlighted on the calendar green the times where I'll be studying computer science. Over here in blue, these are my pee breaks. And on yellow, this is what I'm going to be eating. I've only given myself 15 minutes to eat per day.
Shouldn't yellow be pee breaks if you're really smart?
You know, I have to revise my timeline. That's a really good idea. Thank you for that. I've got to change that to yellow. That's going to take me. Now I have to. I put pink in my timeline for the time that I need to revise my timeline. And it's going
to
be good.
I could not unmute my microphone fast enough to ask if yellow should be for pee breaks.
I really like this time. It's so great.
Now, Edison, you did last couple sessions, experience the joys that of it, and stress relieving that alcohol provides.
Edison did, but I will remind you, Edison's vigor. He's a 105-pound weakling now.
He's up to 105 now?
Well, he remember two levels ago, he pumped up his...
Freshman 5 for the nerd.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So he was throwing up for 3 days straight. Headache that didn't stop for a week. It was horrible. The after effects of being drunk... Well, at the time, being drunk was awesome. His horrible vigor just made it a miserable, hellish experience.
So it's like us now.
Yeah, right? So it's going to be a while before he messes around with alcohol.
There is a, a mechanic in the book for bumping your test stats once per semester called blowing off steam. And I believe that if you roll a die to figure out what it is that you're doing to blow off steam, it could cost you a lot of money or it could be something free.
She's nuts.
And I think one of them is the, whatchamacallit? You know, just go out and get drunk. So yeah. Maybe you have a plus one to your test taking this semester. We'll have to see.
I'm not so sure about that, but it's good to know for the future. Especially as the tests get harder and harder.
That's true.
We might have to use that.
I forget the exact mechanics of it, but I do remember seeing that in the book.
I think you're right. Now, Juan Lo, you don't look like you're nervous at all for your... What, you got an architecture exam? What do you got?
Architecture, I've been studying. I think I'm going to do okay.
You look cool as a cucumber. What will you do if you get a 9-1 instead of a 9-8?
Celebrate.
Celebrate? I just gave you a nightmare, hellish experience. You're thinking a 9-1 is something you're going to celebrate? That's going on your permanent record. How are you going to become valedictorian if you get a 9-1?
Edison, we're in the same class. I'm not going to be valedictorian.
Well, if you get a 9-1, you won't. Listen, you know what? I have an extra hour for revising my schedule. I'll take half hour, and I'll create a schedule for you to help you push yourself a little harder.
Everybody gets a text at the same time.
Except me, which my phone's in the bathroom.
Oh, the Star Trek communicator sounds for Edison's phone.
It's Glenn Mack asking you to come visit in his office as soon as you're available.
What?
Is that in your schedule?
Did you guys just get a text from Professor Mack?
Yeah, he wants us to go see in his office. I got time now.
Paying job.
Oh. Let's go.
I am running.
Paying job. On my way.
Wait, how much time do you think it's going to take to talk to him?
We're already gone.
Edison is alone in the room.
Nobody's there except for Edison talking to
him. Guys, wait for me. Wait for me.
Get your hailer.
Come on, hailer.
All right, so you arrive and he's in his office, and he says, I have a job for you guys if you're interested. Another professor, Dr. Rick Barton, he's the head of botany and agricultural science
here.
He's asking for some help locating something. The other night he spent the night out in the big thicket, which you guys recognize as the big forest that's one of the landmarks. Doing some research, when he got back, he found his house was in shambles. And several valuables are missing, along with a historic artifact he had found over by the sawmills in the outskirts of the Big Thicket some time ago. It's actually a big hook used for dragging the logs onto the conveyor and such. And he called the cops, and Detective Bishop is investigating. But insurance is going to cover the damages and the lost money and valuables, but there was no way to associate a value with the hook. And because it's a historic artifact that was never appraised or anything, he just found it a couple years ago and held on to it.
It's a hook?
Yeah, it's a...
It's a long...
Big logging hook.
Big logging hook.
All right.
I can show you a picture if you like.
Not like what a pirate has when they lose a hand.
No.
All right.
I know what you did last summer, hook.
Yeah. That was scary.
Trust the gore.
I didn't sleep for days.
So he'd like to hire you guys to do some events. Well, he came to me to see if I knew anybody, and obviously I know you guys have some skills in this area. From some of the favors you've done for us. So he's looking to hire some people to do some investigating and a little digging and see if they can find this hook and find who took it.
How hard could it be, guys?
I don't know. If there's a guy running around with a hook, sounds dangerous to me, but I'm curious.
Probably about as hard as it is to go dig up old stuff in Mexico.
How much does this job pay?
He's got a $500 reward for when it's complete.
$500 for each of us or to share?
To share.
$100 a piece.
Your budget for the semester is like $2,000. You don't have a huge budget, so this is a lot of money for you.
That sounds like
that's big money.
Yeah, I agree.
No way.
You guys in?
That's a lot of beer and pizza.
Well, we don't need to buy the pizza. Have we expended our pizza?
And this semester.
Oh man, nice.
I'm in.
You progress to the point now where you're ordering the Hawaiian pizza because it's free. And you can't eat any more regular pizza. you're trying anchovies. You're trying everything.
Oh boy,
sick of pizza?
No.
Professor Mack, a side question. I know you've been researching that crystal skull that we found a month ago. Just wondering, has anything turned up on that?
The crystal skull. I thought I told you that the crystal skull acts as a ritual conduit. It gives you a +1 for ritual. However, if you fail with a 1, you would destroy the skull.
I forgot about that.
Sounds like you need a skull.
No, it just gives you +1 to your roll.
Yeah.
Thanks. It was the other talisman you found that he's still researching.
Oh, the cross. The cross. And that's what I was meant to inquire about.
Yeah, right, that cross. Did you learn anything about that?
Haven't had a lot of time by that. I do have classes to teach.
What are you doing right now? You're waiting for the students to turn in their finals, right?
Well, actually, I have several students out in the field doing some research. I'm reading some term papers. And
Professor, we understand that cross is yours to bear. I get it.
I will tell you, I've had an extraordinarily bad run of luck since I've come into my possession.
Really? What's happened?
Just weird, bad stuff.
You lose your car?
Well,
no,
better than
the car.
Better in your possession than ours.
Did you lose your girl?
No, it is not. This is not a country.
We live in East Texas.
It's a good point.
That just happens all the time.
Did your dog die?
No, my dog ran off with my ex-wife. No. In my pickup truck. With my gut.
She's such a filthy bitch.
So do we go to meet up with your colleague? What was his name?
Here's his name. It's Dr.
Blaine?
Blaine.
Dr. Rick Barton.
Oh, never mind.
Blaine Bishop was the detective.
Oh, yeah.
You met him once before.
Mm.
Or twice before, actually. You met him after the first night in the roost. He was there. You didn't really meet him. He was in the room.
That's right.
And then when you did your scavenger hunt, you met him.
Yep.
Okay.
Danny Glover.
That's right. Danny Glover. And that's his address right there?
He gives you Glenn Mack. His card gives you the address.
And when is he expecting us?
Here's his number. Give him a ring. He's home today. The police are doing an investigation, so he probably should be there almost all day. If you want to give him a ring, or just go out there and take a look around.
Sounds good. We'll go check it out. We'll let you know what we find.
Right.
Do you happen to have any, although the detection equipment, do you think we might need something like that for this?
I mean, he had a couple of artifacts he's dug up from out about. I don't know if anything ever, supernatural has occurred and noticed from them. Yeah, let me see what I got here. And he gives you a couple of pieces of infrared checker and see if it gives off extra heat.
We'll take good care of them.
Gives you a PKE meter.
Should we get 250 up front? I mean, that's usually how business goes.
Professor Max, a professor.
Yeah, but I don't...
He's paying us
for
other jobs.
For results. You get paid for results.
All right.
Get college kids. We can only trust you so much.
I've worked in the front of the site.
Gone.
You don't get a 50 results. Just for signing up for the test.
It's a good idea.
And why isn't he just going to the police?
Well, the police are there investigating for valuables, but they don't care about
a lying stick of undetermined value.
Correct.
All right. Okay.
Oh, rusty hook.
It took me a long time to get over that hurdle in my mind. Hmm. I didn't have a good reason.
Glad you could help.
No, I came up with that. That was the reason I came up with it.
All right.
Well, I don't know about you guys, but I think I can fit some time in my schedule now. I've got about 2 hours I probably can spare. I was going to eat and spend some time
in the paint.
Taking a shower, but and that was reserved for sleep, but I can do that later. You go now?
Yeah, I think while the iron's hot.
Should we give him a call before we show, just in case?
No.
to show up there?
Yes.
Well, that seems reasonable. All right, then. Let's go.
All right, so you guys head out, and you typically go in Joe Diffie's vehicle, right? Joe Diffie's pickup. His Jeep or pickup.
Yeah,
We all jump in the Jeep.
If you go in Edison's, it's going to probably break down.
So, as you're heading over to the Jeep, Roxanne comes up.
Roxanne!
She won't fit in the Jeep.
Well, no, where are you going?
Gotta go by.
No, where are you going? My new friend here, he was really interested in you guys, and when I told him I knew you, he just insisted on coming along. And he really wanted to talk to you. This is Anthony Hoffman. And Chris, you recognize him. Not so much journalism, but more the television on the video side of it.
Okay.
And he's got a little recorder. And he's like, listen, you know, I've heard some great rumors about you guys. Looks like you're in a big rush to go somewhere. Do you mind if I tag along? Because you sound really, like, you do some really interesting things. And I'd like to, you know, we're doing some investigation and that kind of stuff for a piece we're putting together.
What kind of equipment do you have?
I have my trusty recorder here. I got my cell phone, my video camera in it.
Joe Diffie.
Oh, he's not there.
Yeah, what's up?
Oh, he's there.
Do you think that if we get recorded doing our investigations that maybe someone will catch me on video doing something possibly heroic and then maybe a girl will talk to me?
I think more likely what might happen in this scene is if somebody catches us doing what we're doing, we might get expelled.
But I thought you told me once, Joe Diffie, that girls like bad boys.
They do like bad boys, but do you want to be a bad boy expelled from school who got laid, or would you rather just get laid my way?
Well, I still want to be valedictorian, and if I get expelled, that's not going to happen. So clearly, I'd prefer the second option over the first.
You might be useful, guy.
As I've told you, Edison, I'm always looking out for your best interests.
I wonder if that camera's got infrared. Anthony, has it got infrared? All the spectrums on it?
No, it's just a telephone.
I'll get the hell out of here. We don't need you.
No, I think it would be good. We could document one of our adventures. Nobody ever believes us when I tell...
Actually,
I thought we were just going out for pizza.
I got a better idea. Anthony, good fodder if we need it.
Is he got a red shirt on?
He does have a red t-shirt on under his little button-down shirt.
Come on.
Anthony, all right, come on, fodder. Let's go.
I think it's great that you are taking an interest. I think that's wonderful. You can finally see what we've been trying to show other people.
I think only if Roxanne comes, he can.
That's very difficult.
No.
Wait, hold on a second. I know it's a Jeep and it's designed for off-road, but it's not designed for Roxanne.
you get in the Jeep and you turn the key and it just goes click.
Uh-oh, mechanic skills. Should have raised it.
Sounds like that might be something like an alternator, perhaps. Joe, you got a...
I got my van here. Why don't we all just go? This is Anthony. Why don't we all go in here?
He's got his van.
I can drive you around then. It won't even cost you any gas. I can expense this.
Wait a sec. Let's open the hood to see if there's any...
I could take a look at the hood, but we could go in his cool van. He's even paying
for
gas.
It says free candy on his... No.
It's black. It has free candy. Come on, let's go. Let's go.
It's a spaghetti gate stains on a shirt that's really creeping me out.
He's a messy eater, but his name's Anthony. He's Italian. You know they do. Not Italian.
Italian. All right, Anthony. Anybody want to go with Anthony?
I'll go with Anthony.
I don't think we have much of a choice, guys.
So the complication was breakdowns. So the car broke down. But unfortunately, there is room for Roxanne, and she hops right in there. So
nice.
Pony's up next to Wanlo in the back seat.
You just hear.
No, Wanlo wedged herself in a shotgun.
She's fine. It's got a bench seat in the front. She's not getting you out of the way.
Oh God.
And her hand goes right on your thigh. It is like an iron grip.
And warm and sticky.
That's
just like buying out of a sticky bun. She probably did have her hand in a
sticky bun. Oh, Wanlo, this is so exciting.
I just stared out the window. Anyway, it's more like, you know.
Glued to the window's open. It's like a dog right now.
I dare talk about Roxanne that way.
Which one's a song? And her hand was steadily moving up.
All right, so where are we going, guys?
Oh, parents just don't understand.
Thank you.
So where are we going, guys?
We've got an investigation. Now we're going to go head up to the house.
Okay, that's on the far side of town, I think.
Doctor.
Is this like the mystery van?
No, it's not the Mr. Van.
Is Velma going to lose her glasses while then Fred and Daphne can go off and bounce chicka bounce bounce?
So for those of you who have grown up and lived in Shelton, you'll remember there is a van with the Death Star painted on the side. You used to see the log. You haven't seen the log yet. No, it's not that.
Van art.
So,
Roxanne, what are you studying anyway?
I'm still undeclared. Right now, I'm just general studies.
Oh, all right. Okay.
But you know, I'm thinking of studying Oriental studies.
Oh.
I think you're just taking up space and lots of it.
I'm not Oriental. I'm Asian.
Asian studies.
Oriental?
You
what's wrong with you?
You mean buffet?
Rugs are Oriental.
All you can eat?
What about Asian?
What'd you say, Mike?
I said, I think you're just taking up space and lots of it.
She failed out of culinary school because she ate all the food.
You guys aren't very nice, are you? Here she is taking an interest. I mean, I would kill to have a person.
So, Wanda, why don't you tell me stories of where you came from?
My mom.
Actually, you know, I think that Edison was saying that he wanted to tell you about the programs he would write on the computer as a kid. It was some very, very fascinating stuff. He told me the stories already. They were very good. I think you should listen to him.
Oh, yeah, it's true. Back in the day.
Yeah, but Edison.
Yeah?
I wanted to hear one of those stories.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
My stories are boring.
Could you whisper those in my ear? You won't bore anybody else.
Juan Lo, would you just tell her you're gay already? And she'll stop.
Wait, Juan Lo's not gay.
Did you see the show I came home from?
Juan Lo, go ahead and kiss Anthony. Just show her you're gay. Kiss Anthony.
He's not, but Juan Lo's not gay
he
at
is.
All.
He is.
No,
go
really
kiss
is
Anthony.
Timing.
He wants to.
He's a very romantic soul.
He'll do
so
it if he needs
to. The van starts up and he puts the GPS on. He heads out.
I turn the music way up. It could be country, you know, whatever. I will just turn it up.
It's
I look for the Christian station.
It's classic rock.
Turn it up, man.
We'll turn it up.
I love this song. It's a great song. I divorce, I have not no
voice. You don't even know the words.
No. All I got to do is make it loud enough and move my mouth like I do.
All right, so it takes the usual 20-30 minutes.
You're putting up the radio loud. You're
I
like
can't
a,
hear you.
You're a bad boy.
Shh, you're ruining the music.
He's like a bad boy.
No, I'm not.
That's why the girls like him.
That's right.
Her hand is still on your thigh.
Like
and also,
I'm very aware of that.
You're, there's going to be like, you're going to be a fingerprint off you by the time you get to where you're going.
As long as it doesn't move up.
Roxanne, did you know that Juan Lo was in a gang back in the day? He's a bad boy. He's a bad boy.
Edison,
you're ruining the music. Stop it talking.
Oh, sorry.
Stop talking.
Don't hurt me, because I know you have all sorts of crazy killer moves, like that day that you fed off that entire gang and saved our lives.
She's
one dog.
She's all over. She's whispering in your tongue.
Okay, at least I'm okay. The Lord don't want you. Just...
So
I'm bored again.
She's pretty persistent. We'll just leave it at that for the ride. You pass your favorite pizza place. You pass Mom's Diner, where you know.
You guys keep as I try and leap out of the car window. You guys drag me back in.
You know where the chili from the fire chili's from.
Oh, the good stuff.
The good stuff.
The chili.
Did you need to stop for some?
we need to stop for some chili. That'll take care. Everybody eat some chili. That'll get Roxanne out of the car.
What's that? She what's that? Dean, I can't hear you. The music's too loud.
Who has the book? The family eats you.
Giant's got it.
We should go order in that guy.
There's a lot of stores we still haven't visited. Like the guy who sells weapons. We haven't picked up weapons for ourselves yet. Maybe next.
There were two pawn shops. There was.
Well, we've been tracking our money so diligently.
Yeah. You were really good at that. So.
Just like we were in D&D. I want this. Yeah, sure.
We had so much money in D&D, it was ridiculous.
Well, you guys never spent it. At least I gave Josh a wish list.
Yes.
I even got some of the stuff on my list.
You gave me the effort. I gave it back. All right, so you've traveled to the far side of town. You haven't really spent much time here. It's mostly residentials. It's a cute little house. You walk in. There's the unmarked car outside, which you assume is Blaine Bishop's. There's probably the only other police cruiser in town is there. Maybe they have two. They have a college son. So, there's a...
They have rent-a-cops on the university, right?
No, they have a few real ones. They have both.
Okay.
Because, you know, They do actually have things bad happen there. They might have learned a lesson. They might have learned a lesson. So there's a an official-looking guy out there, based on the description that Glenn Mack gave you. You assume that's that is Dr. Rick Barton. And he's talking to Blaine Bishop. And another cop is taking notes.
We'll look around the house. Do a little investigation around the house.
All right. You guys all wandering around? You can...
Maybe we should introduce ourselves first so they don't know anyone here. They don't like
just you guys
ask
go.
Us.
I'm just
gonna You're going to go wander? Okay.
Yeah, I'm going to look around.
Edison's going to go near and wait for an opportunity to introduce himself.
Okay.
Yep.
Yeah.
No, I'm going to look around.
I'll do a notice check from where I am.
But... Sure. Everyone give me a notice check.
You want a 4 over here?
Oh, somebody's going to get a 17. I'm not going
to lie. I don't have a 4. Oh, I don't have a 4 here. Oh, no, I do. I do.
5. So, Diffy, are you wandering? Are you paying attention? Are you going to wait for your turn to talk to...
No.
Sure.
No, I got one.
I was... well, you said do a notice check, so I was just doing that, but I was...
Yeah, everybody give me a notice check, and I can...
5.
I
got 7. A 10.
Ooh. You got a 10.
Close
enough. That beats me. All right, so Joe notices where the cops are spending a little more time. It looks like a window is forced open. You know, as you kind of nonchalantly look over there, you can see there's some damage to it, like a pry bar or something was crammed in there somehow. Yeah, it wasn't done well, but it wasn't done poorly. There's no kicked-in door or anything like that. You can't see anything within the building.
Anybody got a little tracking?
I got 54.
We'll look around a little bit, a little deeper.
The Blaine Bishop and Rick Barton are still talking, and Blaine goes, "What are you guys doing here? Get over here."
Oh, hey.
Hey.
How's it going there, detective?
Well, I'm writing a report for the newspaper, and Anthony over here is videotaping it for us. And
he's video recording away.
Local burglary. This is what we do, and we're just asking a couple questions.
Yeah, but I know these fellas. They have a hard time staying out of trouble sometimes.
We'll keep them in line. They're here to help me out.
And actually, Dr. Barton intervenes and says, "Actually, I've asked them to assist looking for the historical hook that I'm missing because I know you said you wouldn't be able to do much with that."
So that's right.
He's kind of forced to back off a little bit. You can tell he's not particularly thrilled to see you there. Just stay out of the way of the investigation. You won't have any trouble then.
Just stay out of the way of our very important investigation as well, and we'll be just fine.
You'll be investigating
Mr.
the
Mr. Officer,
cell.
Sorry about that, sir.
Sure.
Really sorry about that.
Are you contaminating the scene, Officer Blaine?
See, guys, I'm bad. I'm a bad boy.
Roxanne. Juan Lowe notices Roxanne take a quick peek at Edison.
Oh, boy.
Roxanne. What day of the week is this? Is it Sunday?
You should get all scared.
It's Thursday.
Okay. I'm so scared. One of these days we're going to play on a Sunday. We're going to have to go to church.
That's why we don't do it on Sunday. Sunday's football day, man.
Yeah. you go to 8 o'clock mass, you get home, you have lunch, you watch football.
Or you're like everybody else here. They sleep at the football.
But then when you go to mass, you go to Saturday night. Saturday after 4 is okay.
Yeah.
According to God, that's Sunday too. I don't understand it, but that's what they tell me.
Sundown somewhere?
Yeah. It's Sunday in Australia.
All right. So, Dr. Martin, thanks. Thanks, guys, for coming. You know, I know that you've done some good work for our mutual friend. The cops are clearing up and heading out at this point. But can I help you at all? I have some pictures of it. It's missing. He showed you a couple pictures of the hook.
What does the hook look like? How big and stuff?
It looks like a hook.
It's a round wooden handle with a hook that comes out between the two of the fingers.
Oh.
Hook is about a foot and a half long. Big, sharp, pointy end on it.
Is it like shiny chrome type?
No, it's pitted in more because it's old.
Okay, just making sure.
The handle's kind of...
What was its general purpose?
They used it to drag logs onto the conveyor when they're sawing them. They found it over by the old sawmills on the far side of the thicket.
Does it have any special history that you're aware of?
So, some people claim that it was the hook of...
Captain.
Of Bloody Jim.
Oh, that sounds very comforting.
I think it's just a generic hook. You know, 100 of those things kicking around out there.
Yeah.
Yeah, there's 100 bloody gins. I can't tell you how many times I see them in history books. It's crazy.
So, who's Bloody Jim? Do we remember him from somewhere?
What's the lore on Bloody Jim?
Lore on Bloody Jim. Oh, you guys never heard of Bloody Jim?
No, never have.
Okay. Juicy. So, according to legend, back when there was a lot of logging out in the Great Thicket, there was a guy there named Jim Jenkins. He was
Old Man Jenkins.
Old Man Jenkins.
He was not afraid to throw a punch or swing a hammer at somebody.
Right.
And he was a... A
lot of hammers in the logging business?
Now Edison, that's what a bad boy is.
Sledgehammer?
Yeah, Joe Diffie, you're right.
I've never been logging. Oh, I guess to split.
So, he worked at the lumber mill for a while. He was operating the sawmill. He was pretty mean to the crews. And apparently he pushed one guy too far one time. And Big Harold put our good friend Jim Jenkins into the saw.
And that's why it became all bloody?
And they buried him unceremoniously there, and rumor has it every once in a while his ghost shows up and
the songbird is
terrorizes the area. So,
roast?
I mean, if I could attach that hook back to him, it'd be worth a fortune in the area at least. Mm. But to me, it's just a hook, you know.
Why did you keep it then if it wasn't worth anything to you?
Well, it's still a neat historical artifact.
Oh, all right.
I mean, let's face it. Do you have a 12-foot hook hanging out in your, you know, to display at your house?
12-inch hook.
That would be very dangerous. I'm not sure if I'd get hurt walking past it. I'd worry about tripping or something. It seems like it would be quite a danger.
Actually, use it as a hat rack.
Oh, that's very creative. Wow. So Harry hit bloody and
killed. So Big Harold and Jim Jenkins tussled, and Big Jim ended up on the wrong side of it. And
What happened to Big Harold? Did he ever get tried or convicted for killing him? I mean, that's murder, man.
Murder or not, the crew was all happy and everybody was working. It was back in the early 1900s, which was almost it was a western town back then.
Slipped on the sawdust, basically.
Yeah, it was an accident. Horrible, messy work accident.
Is there anybody who also collects items? Like, do you have any competitors who also like to collect items who might have wanted the piece from your collection?
I mean, everybody, everybody around here has stuff they found. I know the Pinebox Historical Society likes you to hand some stuff in from time to time if you find it. There's probably some private collectors in town that I'm not familiar with.
Who knew you had the hook?
Who knew that it might have been attached to Blade Jim?
Any number of people. It's just a...
wasn't a secret. You were
no, there was no secret about it. Yeah, I have an open house for students from time to time. I'm friendly with numerous neighbors who've been over here.
They run the stuff that you lost to the pawn shops in the area?
It just happened this morning, so I would assume the cops are investigating.
So how did you discover it was missing? You woke up and...
Well, no, I came home because I was out in the thicket doing some research on his body.
And his house was...
And the house was burglarized.
So it was okay. Like, you left at what time, and what time did you return?
I left in the evening last night because it was a flower that blooms more at night. Oh. So I went out there, and when I came back, the house was broken into, and I was missing a couple pieces of jewelry and the hook and some cash.
What time period were you away from your house so we can narrow down the window?
Probably left around 5 at night. Got home around 7 this morning.
All right. So we could, if anybody's got an alibi for that time period, then that makes it harder.
What did you notice first when the house was broken and the door kicked in? Window I can see is broken.
Yeah, no, I came in and I opened up the door because the window was off kind of the side.
Was the door locked?
The door was locked there. Everything was okay. And then when I opened, I noticed the window was open. I knew I wouldn't have left it open, and that's when I got suspicious and investigated.
Well, if it was a ghost that stole the hook, they could have just passed through the walls, taken the hook, and then left.
How would they have gotten the hook out, Edison? Come on.
Well, they would smash it through the window. And then
the glass wasn't broken. Just the lock was broken.
Oh, I thought the window was open? Or broken?
It was broken. The lock was broken, and the window was forced open.
Oh, the window and the lock and the window was broken.
Yeah.
Okay. What were you studying out in the woods?
So funny how...
We all have
how the vision differs.
Yeah. Well, what were you studying out in the woods, in the big thicket?
I was investigating some flowers that bloom differently at night.
Oh. That doesn't sound like a very good clue.
Do you mind if we look around the residence a bit for additional clues?
Be my guest. I don't have anything to hide. I mean, like I said, it is what it is. I was hoping to get it back because I liked it.
All right.
Is the area where you found it still an area that's investigated? Or did, like, the old lumber mill? Is that where the old sawmill?
Yeah, there's a whole bunch of sawmills out on the far side of the thicket. People go out there all the time. There's nothing. Mm-hmm. Sometimes kids party out there because they go inside the buildings. They aren't real safe, but they'll go party in there or something like that. Every once in a while, somebody gets hurt or lost out there. That happens because people are reckless.
Or lost.
Safety first.
Yeah. Edison turns on the PK meter and slowly approaches the window.
No activity there.
Guys, I don't see any activity on the PK meter.
Can you show us where in the house you kept the hook?
Sure. So he takes you over and there's actually he has a little study, a little box display. You know, I mean, four or five things in there. And it opens up, and that happens as a spot that was where it was missing.
Is anything else?
So all the other stuff is still in there?
All the other stuff is in there.
And you said what else was taken? Some jewelry? And
some personal jewelry. You know, and a couple of rings of mine. And some cash I had stashed away.
Anything significant about the rings?
One was my class ring. And one was just a fancy ring I wear out for events.
Just a silly question, Doc Martin. Shoes.
So my name's not Martin. It's Barton.
Oh, I got close. I was so close. You didn't happen to have any security in your house, did you? Alarms, cameras?
Nah, this is Texas.
I got my security right here.
You weren't wrong.
You know, in Texas, there's an easy form of security for the future. They call it a dog. You should get yourself a dog in the future.
I'll take that under advisement.
Sure thing. I'm happy to help, sir.
Are you trying to do your Wesley Crusher impression?
So basically what I think we got here is somebody broke in specifically for this item and then stole some jewelry and some money to make it seem like it was a regular burglary. But...
Or just to make a little bit more profit off of it.
We investigate that window a little bit more, look at that window a little bit more, fingerprints. We go ahead and go over.
Okay.
And take a look at it. I'm going to ask Doc Martin, that's his name now, if I could borrow some flour. An old trick I saw on TV once.
I would give you some if I had any. I don't really bake.
Everybody's got flour.
Everybody's got flour.
Baking soda. Cocaine.
Talcum powder.
Oh, wait, I got that.
Try talcum powder.
Talcum powder.
Oh, I do get the occasional rash here.
Yes.
Powder sugar. Beautiful.
So I'm going to go over the window and see if I can't blow a little on the window to see if I can't.
Inside or outside?
Both.
On the inside, there's fingerprints all over it. Okay. Probably his.
Right.
On the outside, you don't see anything.
A man with no fingerprints.
Wait, you mean to tell me the police were here investigating and they didn't fingerprint the window frame?
Mike, have you ever had your house broken into? I don't know about in Shelton, but in Waterbury, they don't give a shit.
Yeah, that's true. They don't
like, oh, well, you got broken
in
into?
Waterbury,
like, what was
in
stolen?
Waterbury,
we'll go talk to the neighbors.
Probably,
yeah, bye.
Yeah. They probably have 37 break-ins a day in Waterbury.
Yeah.
All right.
Are there footprints?
Just seems kind of suspicious.
Want to do a little tracking?
Go ahead, Mike. Sorry.
That's right. Doc Martin, I mean, is there any reason to think that, you know, other than the fact that this might have belonged to Bloody Jim, is there any other thing that you know, noticed as weird in relation to, I mean, there's nothing that you've ever noticed about this particular, you know, piece?
Not really. I mean, It's got plenty of wear and tear on it. There's marks and nicks all over it. It could be there's some blood on there. You know, it's a well used thing from it's 100 years old.
Mm-hmm.
It's not like I polished it up or anything. I like to, you know, leave the natural patina on it from all the age.
Mm-hmm. Mooney, you're good at looking for stuff, right? Tracks and you got anything? You picking up anything outside that window?
Go out there and take a look.
Don't worry. That's Johnny Moon. In addition to being the star football player and quarterback, he's also a master tracker.
Three. It looks like there's a lot, there's been a lot of people walking in this area.
Looks like there's some shrubbery here.
Nothing in particular.
It's hard for Johnny Moon to tell because the cops are already there looking for that kind of stuff.
Johnny Moon, how much did he weigh? Did he favor his left foot or his right foot?
About 180 pounds.
All right, that's what I thought. You see, he's very good.
Wait, great timing, by
Johnny
way.
Moon, you weigh about 180 pounds.
his right sleeve was just
Wait,
a little bit longer than his left.
I'm good.
Well, guys,
I say we've investigated here enough. I think there's only one other place we should go.
Is there anything left over from what the...
Back home.
Like, we have a ritual that can show if you have a piece of something, what the rest of it looks like. I mean, is there a piece left behind? No, I guess not.
What are some of the other pieces that are in that box? Are they similar in nature to, like, logging operation, or...
It looks like they're pretty generic to the area. So, I mean, there was obviously the hook. There's some old nails that he found. I would say there's a saw blade, but the saw blade would be too big. So, we'll say there's a couple teeth from broken off from saw blades.
Like shark's teeth.
Off a saw blade, not a shark tooth.
Saw blade. Yeah.
Oh, saw blade. I was like, there's sharks in Pinebox.
Joe Diffie, are you getting any psychic impressions?
Small coins.
I'm not feeling anything.
Some old coins.
Doc Barton, do you mind if Joe Diffie here touches some of the items that were found with the hook?
It's going to help get my hook back and touch himself as long as it's in private.
Well, I don't think I'd really appreciate that, but can you tell us which of these items here were with the hook?
I got enough sorority girls to touch me. I don't need to do that myself, Doc Barton.
Were there any items here found with the hook?
Well, I mean, the hook was the only thing that's removed out of this case.
But were there other items that were in the vicinity of the hook when you first found it that was in the same locale? You know, things that...
Maybe some of the sawtooth teeth, because I found those are from all over. All
right.
So I might have found some when I picked up the saw.
Try that, Joe Diffie.
Yeah, we can give that a shot. I mean, theoretically, it's, you know, designed to communicate with supernatural beings, but maybe I can sense something.
And also, if you get the winning numbers for this Friday's Powerball, maybe you could share that with us, too.
I'll make sure to tell you first, Edison.
All right, perfect. Thank you, sir.
Right after I buy my ticket.
Oh, all right.
Anthony turns to Edison and goes, you know, I heard you could download all the winning number tape, all the ring numbers for like the past 10 years, and I'll bet a guy like you could put it in the program... Figure out which numbers come up the most often.
Do you know, I've just finished I'm preparing for my final in SAS, statistical analysis software, and that is a fine idea. I could use a prop correlation and cross-tab it against that.
Can I come help? We'll split the winnings. That's my idea.
That's a good son. Idea. All right, sure, of course. We can split the winnings, but I have to solve your mystery first.
This was Anthony, the kid.
Oh, yeah, we have to solve the mystery first, Anthony.
Oh, yeah, of course.
Right.
Roxanne is way close to Juan Lo.
But Edison's looking pretty badass.
Occasionally she's stealing glance at us. Heart's torn.
Alright, so I'm getting intimate with the other objects in the case.
Alright, so
you make a roll?
You know, what the
yeah, they GPS. There's nothing really exciting about them. You know,
okay.
I'm sorry, Mike.
No, that's okay. I mean, it was worth a shot.
Yeah.
PK meter and the infrared on the inside. We did the outside, but anything on the inside?
There's a very faint glow where the hook was.
Where the hook was. Guys,
For the infrared.
I could be wrong, but take a look on the infrared. Do you see what I'm seeing over here?
Looks a little hot over there.
Yeah, where the hook was. So maybe there was something to the hook.
Maybe it got up and walked away.
Let's see if there's anything else there.
Oh, anything else hot? Of the rest of his collection, you mean?
All right, so you scan the room. Nothing jumps out at you.
Okay.
Nothing's hot. You know, the shelves of books would put anybody to sleep.
Mm. You know. Edison is fascinated by them.
See how this one's bound?
Exactly.
See this bookcase, how it's designed and cut it? It's not the guy that's the...
I think we got what we need here, guys. I think we should go and see if we can do a little bit more research on this bloody gym.
I'm wondering if he thinks that he's around. Should we go to a local historian, or do you think we should hit the library?
I think we should go to that little bookstore we went to and talk to our friend there who runs it. She's got a lot of information. She might be able to point us in a good direction to start.
That's Mary Lynn's Used Books and Emporium.
Mary Lynn.
Yes, Mary Lynn.
I remember Trout had a good relationship with her.
Best report.
That's too bad. Trout's taking his oil accounting final right now.
I thought he got called back to help with the family business.
Oh, he got called back to help with the failing business?
Maybe that's it.
That's the official story.
That's where he's taking his finals.
No, that's Joe Diffie.
Yes.
That's where he's taking his midterm finals.
Okay.
He has a chance to pass. All
right. So,
Veronica's taking my final right now.
What are you up to?
So we're going to go to Mary Jo's coffee shop.
Okay.
And we are going to see if she has any additional details on the hook itself.
Okay.
Or on maybe anything she knows about Bloody Jim.
Or Bloody Jim. Or even people who might have wanted to collect the hook.
Well, because what I'm wondering about is if this thing was showing up on the infrared, right, we've got the potential that somebody specifically went into the house for that particular hook, stole the rings and the other stuff to make it look like a robbery, hopefully to throw everybody off. On the hook itself, and what I'm worried about is this thing's going to get used in some sort of ritual somewhere, and we're going to be finding some body somewhere, body may be one of us.
It's a red herring. It's the ring that's really important.
Red herring. I think Joe Diffie's onto something here. I think, no offense there, but it sounds like Joe Diffie's got the right idea.
You watch me. I've done a lot of these before. It's the ring.
Anthony, are you getting all this video?
Yep.
This is great, right?
Do you want to recap some of it in the car while we're driving, we're going?
Well, I'm not good at recapping anything. I can't even get the cap back on the camera.
Just as a note, Ford, you're a reporter, and you people never get anything right.
Trust me.
You're like weatherman.
The most important thing is to get to print, not to get accurate.
Reporters are like the weathermen. They might be right 50% of the time.
That's always real lucky.
Yeah.
I've got a good bit. No, I don't have a good investigation. Anyway.
All right, so you head on back to...
More water for you?
Mary Lynn's Used Books and Emporium.
Thank you. Would you like water?
Sure. Yeah. And Mary Lynn happens to be in. It's a coffee shop.
Thanks.
Thank you. I haven't seen you guys in a while. How's your first semester working out?
It's hard, but we're doing pretty well.
Really?
We're still here.
Yep.
Yeah, most people aren't here after the first year. No, they fail out.
Oh, I thought you meant because a lot of crazy stuff that goes on.
There's that too. Some of them just don't come back.
The smart ones.
Edison has graph paper out, and he seems to be intently recoloring things. I have to readjust. We've shot past my 2-hour time limit, and now I have to compress everything to account for another 4 hours. I think it's going to be 4 more hours. Excuse me, sorry.
It's just graph paper. I thought you were drawing a dungeon.
No, it's his revision. It's his revision of his timeline.
You want to do that on his phone?
So,
he likes to do it old school.
So I turn to Maryland after we order some coffees and stuff, and I say, hey, so we heard a story about an old logger back in the logging camps by the name of Bloody Jim.
Oh, that's a good story.
Can you help fill in some gaps on that? We might be investigating something that might be related to him, and your insight has proved invaluable in the past, and we'd love to know what you can offer for us on anything about that story. And
sure. So what have you heard so far?
Well, not a whole lot, other than the fact that, you know, he was not the most well-liked of loggers. And Big Harry or Henry or whatever, and him got into an altercation. And
Big Harold,
Henry, Hank. Anyway, they got into an altercation, and he accidentally fell into the saw and got pretty mangled.
Well, actually, his head got cut off from his body.
You know the hymns now.
All right, that's slightly different version than what we heard, but yeah. Okay.
And supposedly every once in a while his restless spirit wanders around out there.
Headless or head with a head?
Carrying the head under his arm.
Carrying like you did.
And
it's normal.
And he has a big hook in his other hand that he'd used previously to, you know, drag things down to the conveyor for the saw.
How big a hook would you say?
I don't know. They're all pretty big. I mean, it's probably 12, 16 inches long. Not something you want to run into.
Yeah, no, I imagine not. I mean, if the guy's got a big hook in his hand.
Was anything in his stories about the hook? Was there, like, did he do anything special or really bad with the hook? Like, you know.
Well, the history tells that he comes back every once in a while, scaring people, and eventually somebody will die, and then the spirit will go away for a while.
Except to sacrifice something.
So let me ask you a question. If for some reason we actually knew where his actual hook was, or if somebody actually had the actual hook that Bloody Jim used to use, do you think that might be used for some sort of a ritual to maybe bring him back or something? Could it be used for
some sort
of a ritual?
I don't pretend to be a ritual expert. That might be a question for that. What's that guy's name at the university?
Professor McDonald?
Glenn
McDonald.
Oh, Glenn Mack.
He would be the guy to ask about that, but based on my limited knowledge of rituals, yeah, you could probably try to summon his spirit back if you had the hook or something like that.
Mm. Sounds like a complicated murder plot.
Wow.
That's I don't know if you can control it, but you could summon it back and talk to it, maybe.
This would be great for television. We have to do this. This would be so exciting. We have to do this. This is a great idea.
This is an hour-long episode. Edison, no more coffee for you, man. Seriously.
What would somebody, what kind of knowledge would he have? Like, why would anybody want to talk to him?
Some people just like historical figures.
Shits and giggles.
Do you think anybody could, I mean, if they had this hook for some reason, do you think they might be able to use it for, maybe not necessarily summoning him back, but maybe for some other part of a ritual?
I mean, certainly it could be used as a weapon. Maybe you could substitute that in some sort of ritual. I don't know. I would think if you had specifically been looking for his, that it would definitely affect him specifically. Mm. Roxanne puts her arm around Wanlow's. There's a shiver just right up my spine, and she snuggles in close.
Yeah, you need some more coffee, and get here. Extract my arm.
So you said the story is that when he does come back, somebody dies.
Usually, from what I understand, and the Pinebox Historical Society might be able to tell you more, but usually...
I forgot this place is called Pinebox.
Usually somebody dies, and that seems to satisfy the spirit or placate it for a while. That's the rumor. It hasn't come up very often.
When's the last time somebody's gone missing?
I don't know. I've only been here for a couple of years.
It's Pinebox. The last time somebody went missing was like 20 minutes ago.
So you're saying nobody's gone missing from Bloody Jim since you've been around town?
Right, but I mean, I only bought this place a few years ago.
It's okay. It's still a couple of years, though. So
your next stop should be the Historical Society.
I'm thinking the Historical Society. Is anybody there at this time of night?
It's late afternoon, so late they might be there.
We went down at like 11:30.
Lose track of the time, you know.
Well, we appreciate your time and everything you do for us.
You're welcome.
Maybe we'll actually need a book or a stick book for me once in a while.
Yeah, I mean, if you guys need anything, I got, you know, I got my extensive, I got some crystal stuff here, I got some oil stuff, I got some aura stuff, I got some ritual stuff, I got some, and she just goes on and on and on.
Nice. I'll take some patchouli.
I do have some components over here for those of you who are into... You know, I sell the oils and then all that kind of stuff. Is she sleeping over there?
She's using the horn as a pillow.
Right over there.
Yeah. Well, so check your eyes.
I could have sworn I just heard.
Yeah.
Yeah. I was breathing deeply.
And for the people listening, and Mike, I don't think, Mike, you're aware of this. Chris came in today with a big burlap sack.
Oh, I need
huge.
I need the burlap sack back, by the way.
And it's filled with a ton of
ears of corn. It's just piled.
Oh, okay.
Corn. So now Jeff is laying down on top of the corn. And it's a massive amount of corn. How many ears are in that, Chris?
I have no idea.
Well, how are in a bushel?
Maybe 25.
Maybe 25?
A bushel and a pack.
It was 50, I think, before. I gave away. Good.
Children of the corn.
Mm-hmm. Please, want to make sure we got some.
All right, so I think we head over to the Pine Box Historical Societies.
Agreed.
Yeah.
And see what we can ascertain from the historian.
Historian?
The Dorian?
All right.
Want to see how the Dorian?
Yeah.
So you get there, and there's a woman sitting in the area.
In a rocking chair.
She's sitting out. Not, actually, she's rocking in a chair on the front, on the porch. Is that a society?
Does she have any teeth?
Yeah, you actually recognize her.
They're in her pocket, though.
God.
What?
I just picture her, like, Texas. On the rocking porch, she should have a shotgun.
No. You recognize her from the university. Actually, Trout would know her, but she's the Special Reserves Librarian, so she controls access to the
secret.
The special books that are, you know, the very rare ones that they don't put out for anybody or anything like that.
Restricted section.
Yes. Some fun songs like
that. Sorry. Would she know us at all, or?
She would know Trout, but I don't think she's recognized you guys.
Okay.
Well, that doesn't help us.
You might be able to mention your friend Trout.
We can mention that Trout sent us.
So you come walking up. Hi, boys. And lady.
Hey. Howdy, baby.
What are you doing here at the Historical Society? I rarely get college students come on down here.
We're just interested in the history of Pine Box, particularly a story we heard about a guy named Bloody Jim, an old logger.
Well, that is one of our.
We're going to hear a little bit more about that.
That is one of the darker stories and curses around here, supposedly.
Curse? Nobody told us it was a curse.
That Jim Jenkins was a logger. He ran one of the sawmills. And he was brutal on his men. He treated them like slaves. And then one day, a guy named Big Harold stood up to him, and they tussled. And Jim got tossed into the blade and came out headless. Huh. Now that supposedly the area is cursed, and whoever every once in a while somebody disappears out there.
You know, and this is a great...
disappears out by the logging camp where he used to be, or at the specific logging camp he was in. Because there aren't a couple different ones.
There's 8 or 10 mills within a few mile radius.
Okay.
You know,
they're all decommissioned and you know, 100 years old.
Are any of the old saws still there? Like, I mean, if we went out there, could you see the?
If you went out there, you could probably see some of the, you know, the teeth have probably rotted off, but you could see the big old blades and the pulley systems they use that run everything.
That's pretty cool. That's a part of history I'd love to see.
Well, here, let me get the map for you. She pulls out a map and she shows you how you got there, and it's not a bad ride. You'd have to park the van and be a couple mile trek into the woods. Is by a river so that they could, you know, send the logs up and down.
Do you mind if we get a picture of that, man?
You can take the flyer with you.
Oh, thank you very much. Here it is for the camera. Here it is for your video. See that?
Doing better than him.
Ooh. Very ominous.
Thank you.
Yeah, you will. Wait. Look, I can hold it close to me and then put it close to you, in and out. That's kind of spooky.
No, that's going to make people throw up.
Oh, yeah. Ooh, spooky. All right, I'm going to stop.
Yeah, we don't want Edison throwing up, because that's just yucky.
No, I've had
he already did it for 3 days.
Yeah, that was beginning of last year.
that was his roommate's problem, not mine.
Did he just make himself up, sorry? Before
he said he's choking or something.
I think I'm going.
So we heard that big bloody Jim used to have a hook or something, too?
Yeah, I'm not really the Bloody Jim expert. If you really want to talk to the guy who's researched that a lot, you want to find Ken Hart. He's been almost obsessed with Bloody Jim.
Oh, interesting, because we're trying to write a paper for the school newspaper, or an article for the school newspaper. So Ken Hart's the guy we should talk to, huh?
Oh, absolutely.
Obsessed with Bloody Jim?
Where do we find Ken exactly?
Let me go check. He's a member of the Historical Society, so I might have his address here.
Hang on. Is he on Facebook? Edison checks social networking to see if he can find Ken Hart.
Yeah, where's he checked in right now?
Is he the president? And then he looks for the Bloody Jim fan club on Facebook as well.
Okay, there's nothing for Bloody Jim on Facebook.
Okay.
Ken Hart likes the Pinebox Historical Society. He's friends with a bunch of people you don't know.
Yep.
You do recognize Sanja's name is one of them.
Hey, guys, look at this. It looks like last Tuesday Ken ate some asparagus. He's got a picture of it right here, see? That looks mighty tasty. He puts mustard on it. That's weird.
Well, asparagus is weird, don't you think? I mean, it's like eating a small tree. I mean,
and then you gotta pee it out later.
Well, this is Texas. You're eating steak. You don't eat asparagus.
That's my point. The only two things in Texas: steers and queers. And Edison, I don't see any horns on your head.
Wait, I don't understand, Joe Diffie. What do you mean?
It's okay, Edison. You'll catch on later.
All right.
I'll fill you in. First, we got to figure out Bloody Jim. Let's go figure out where this guy Ken is, and let's go see if we can talk to him.
All right, she comes back. She has an address for Ken. It's on the outskirts of town.
I asked, do you think he'd be receptive if we just kind of showed up there and asked him some questions?
I don't know what he does for a day job. He may or may not be there. I don't know.
May have a hook?
I don't even know if he's married, to be honest.
Hmm. Ooh, what a weirdo.
Be smart. All right, we're gonna take a
look. This is so exciting.
We're gonna take a ride out to see Kevin Hart. He's also a comedian.
Kevin Hart.
Ken.
you're worse than your brother. It's a Jones thing. Because Bob is probably
interested. It is a Jones thing.
Demonicus.
Yeah.
Yes. So
it's definitely a Jones thing.
Roxanne is all about Wamo. This is so exciting. Now I see why you do this all the time.
Oh, wait till he's right around. It's boring.
No way.
I'd rather be studying.
Well, I'd rather be studying.
Really? I want to read the Bible.
Really?
Yes, Wanlo, what time is the Bible? What time do we get to get you to Bible study tonight, Wanlo?
I heard there was some dirty people in the Old Testament.
A lot of sinners in the Old Testament.
Well, dirty from the fact that they didn't shower?
With you and the sheep.
Whole cities of sinners just
dead. Good sinners. That's what she says. Ask her. She's into a three-way with a sheep.
Throw things at her.
Well, that's not right.
So you just pile in Anthony's van.
Pile in the van?
And Anthony's like, guys, thanks for letting me tag along. I can't wait to review all this footage, edit it down, put it out there for the TV, the university TV station. Awesome.
Anthony, you got some nice plush carpeting in this van. Hey, what Anthony, else are you doing here, my friend?
Oh, there's a waterbed back now.
can I review some of the house footage? Just see how
you still in it? Do you sell candy out of this van?
You took some photos of the house, right?
Yeah.
Only in elementary school.
Yeah, excellent.
Yeah, exactly. Thank you, Adam.
You all, for whatever reason, this camera has 20 pounds. Of course, most of you don't realize that you gained the freshman 15, so it's really only 95.
Edison now looks like he's...
So Roxanne just doesn't fit in the whole frame at all?
And Edison actually only looks like 70 pounds underweight now.
No, Adam Roll whole nose takes up the whole frame.
And now we have a sliding door in the van.
Hey, guys, it's probably about 5 o'clock now. It's starting, it's going to get dark pretty soon. We're going to go out there in the dark?
Yeah.
Go out to Ken's place?
If you're going to be a ghost. Oh, yeah, Ken's place. Yeah, let's go meet Ken. Sure.
In the dark?
It's fine. We're going to some guy's house. Come on. All right, what's the worst that could happen?
Listen, easy. Forward. Worst case scenario, we sacrifice Roxanne.
That's it.
Yeah.
Push her down.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. She's
only the slowest.
Are you out?
We knock her down. We all run. We leave Anthony there to film it.
We're going to stop by the pizza place, pick up a couple of pizzas on our way.
Oh, I like the way you think.
That's what we're going to do.
All right, so you call in first, so it's ready when you get there.
You got it.
Everybody mm-hmm. make sure to pass the pie around and don't let it get to Roxanne.
Make sure she's the last one to get it. Yeah. Guys, there's only one slice left.
Oh, I'll take that.
Oh, I thought you were going to share what you have with me.
Oh, no, never mind. That's like, we both love? No, I'm not going to do that.
I was thinking about saving the pizza for Ken.
God, well, you guys are big students.
All right, so you head up to Ken's house. It actually turns out Ken doesn't live too far away from Rick Barton.
Oh, boy. Doc Martin.
3-4 blocks away.
How convenient.
Do you guys think... Are you guys thinking what I'm thinking?
Yes.
Yes, but where are we going to get a pair of panties at this time of night?
Thank you. Thank you. That wasn't as good. Maybe the thought was there, but it wasn't like.
I didn't know. I had to come up with something quick, and I lost the voice. It just.
For those unfamiliar with Pinky and the Brain for the Animaniacs, go look it up.
And if you're going to look up Pinky, the Animaniacs, you should look up the Nations of the World.
Yes.
When you did the Anatomy of the Brain.
So, Pinky and President.
Listen, all I have to say is what's the definition of insanity?
All right. So you show up. It's a slightly bigger house. There's a car parked in the driveway. Doesn't look like it goes in the garage.
Why is it that you park on a driveway and drive on a parkway? Just saying. Anyway.
And there's a couple kids playing in the front yard. Wife sitting on the front porch watching them.
And you have to pay for tolls on the freeway.
She's wearing a nice little white, little blue dress. Not devil in the blue dress, but
how little?
Not that little. Just above B-line.
Oh.
Just enough for you to say, oh.
Summer dress?
Yeah.
She wore a nice big wide-brimmed hat?
No.
Sipping on some sweet tea.
Because she's in the shade of the deck. She's on the front porch, so she doesn't need a hat. It's off to the side. There's your fantasy. Okay, is your fantasy back
right.
in time?
She's
all right.
She's fantasy. So.
Blonde.
Yeah. Well, it's Texas. I mean, yeah.
Not everything is bigger in Texas. She's kind of petite. Hmm. But only in the right place.
Okay.
You're going to go talk to strangers now?
Isn't it exciting?
This is fantastic. Okay. Roxanne is just like a quiver. This is fantastic. And Anthony's like, I can't wait. I can't wait to go review the footage.
Edison, you're the tough guy. Why don't you go talk first?
Really? You want me to talk to somebody? I'd be happy to. This is great.
Boy.
I'm looking forward to it. I wonder if you like Star Trek The Next Generation. We're going to talk
Joe
about...
Joe Diffie.
Edison, what are we here to talk about?
Well, Star Trek Next Generation.
No, Edison, we drove out here to talk to him about what?
Oh, right. We're going to talk about the hook.
We're going to talk about Bloody Jim. We're going to leave the hook out of the conversation for right now.
Wait, we're not just going to ask him if he took the hook?
That's going to be our hook.
No.
I was just thinking I'd go and I'd say, did you take the hook? Because you live really close to his house.
I know what you were thinking, which is why I'm stopping you from thinking.
Maybe, Roxanne, maybe you and Edison should go take a walk or something together.
Yeah, you guys should take a walk and get to know each other better.
All right, let's go, Roxanne.
Okay, but Wilo's got to come too. She grabs Wilo's hand.
We want you guys to investigate the surrounding houses around here.
I got the PK meter. I'll start looking around.
Ooh, do you know how to work that? Isn't this fascinating, Wilo? Oh, my goodness.
Yeah,
she's like a ping pong ball right now. She doesn't know what to do with herself.
And Roxanne, I understand that there's some wild boars in this area, so I need you to keep Edison safe.
Whoa.
When one of them wild boars comes around, you just jump right on that thing.
Really?
Wouldn't that be incest?
So, for the record, Mike, since you bring it up, there is a monster in here called Hogzilla.
Just
Razorback of enormous size.
There is a Hogzilla. 350
pounds of this creature is more than 20 times larger.
Wow.
You ever seen those on...
Strength D12 plus 6.
Yeah, wasn't that on sci-fi?
Online. No, it's online. It's real.
Toughness 15.
Hogzilla's a real thing.
They have huge wild boar.
Oh, I know that they have wild boar. Like, they have packs
of them. It's the size of a bull elephant on steroids.
That's crazy. Oh my God.
Wow.
Yeah, if a normal one's 350...
That'd be like the ultimate mate for Roxanne.
7,000 pounds.
So...
That's a lot of roasting.
The kids who were playing in the front yard...
That's a lot of bacon. No.
There were two boys in the front yard throwing a football around. They stopped now. They're looking at you like,
Mooney,
I'm out.
Football.
Hey, you guys footballers?
Yeah. Do you play for... I assume you're wearing one of your shirts.
Of course. That's all I have.
Do you play for the university?
Yeah, I do.
Really? What's your name?
Johnny Moon.
Oh, you're one of the incoming freshmen.
Yeah.
Yeah, I saw you. I heard about you. You got some plate tea the other day. It was a pity they sacked the shit out of you like that.
I know, right? I'm sitting next to him.
Well, they're still working on the offensive line.
So what do you guys do? You guys play a little bit?
Oh, we just throw the ball around out here. Mom won't let us play. It's too violent, you know.
This is Eastern Texas. Everybody plays.
Yeah.
Where is she, Yankee?
She's not from around here. She doesn't even like it when I have three guns now.
Two she's okay with. Three?
No, I don't think she likes two, but, you know. We got to do what we can do. Got to keep the peace in the house because they don't want Dad and Mom fighting.
Can the guns help you keep the peace?
No, I cannot get them.
Oh.
Well,
look who's over here.
So. Excuse me, Matt. Boys, please step away from the strangers. Boys, what can we do for you? What can I do for you? And she shoots with the boys around that.
We were hoping we might be able to talk to your husband, Ken.
Ken's not here right now.
Was he expected?
Oh, we're from the university. We're from the university, and we're doing an article for the school paper, and we were down at the Historical Society, and they mentioned to us that your husband was an expert in the paper that in the article that we're writing. This is Ford. He's the editor in chief of our newspaper.
Really, what's the article about?
About the history of the logging camps and Bloody Jim, particularly.
Oh Jesus! No more fucking Bloody Jim. Oh.
Well, not from the kids.
Oh.
They were there. He sent around back. If I have to hear any more about Bloody Jim, I'm gonna bloody somebody.
We don't need you to hear about it, man. We were just hoping to talk to your husband.
Oh my God, that's all he talks about. He's so obsessed with it. I can't take it anymore.
Looks like you could use some relax. Oh, sorry.
That's all it is. Bloody Jim this, Bloody Jim that. I wish I could find the hook. I wonder which sawmill he worked at. Oh, it's just
what hook, man?
Oh, come on. We all know he's familiar with the hook. We know that he stalks the camps at night, carrying his head under one arm with the hook in the other hand, waiting to kill somebody. That's the curse and the rumor, the legend. That's where he is right now, waiting out there, trying to get a picture, trying to see it. You know, it's supposed to be a full moon tonight.
So you think he's actually out at the camps?
Oh, I know he's out there. He's out there every freaking weekend. Sometimes Thursdays. Which today is.
Which today happens to be a Thursday. So what else do you know about this Bloody Jim then?
Oh, what else is there to know? He's a killer. He was a mean guy that somebody killed, cut his head off on the saw. That's a horrible way to go.
Well, it's got to be quick, I guess.
You would think, but if he's still around hunting people, maybe not that quick.
Well, maybe it's not whether it was quick or not. I mean, from what I understand from talking to people so far, he was just a mean, mean man that nobody liked. So nobody was sad to see him go. Maybe that's why he's still around. Maybe if you're all just nice to him for a little bit.
Sorry.
I'm just changing the map, Mikey, for no reason other than to change the display so I don't burn it.
Okay. I lost Adam and Bob, though.
Yeah, we're coming back. Sorry.
Hey, is there a cell phone number we can call him on? Just so we can talk to him?
I give it to you, but I know there's no signal out there. Or if there is, he's just been ignoring me for the past 5 years going out there looking for stuff.
How's the kids?
Do you know exactly where he is? Do you think he'd be upset if we came out there to visit with him while he was there?
Yeah.
This way, if we talk to him out there, then you don't have to hear about it. We don't have to interrupt, and we would hate to interrupt and cause any strife between you and your husband, ma'am.
Oh, thank you. He causes enough of that himself.
Do you have a map of the area? Sounds like it.
Do you have a map of the area?
Yeah.
We do. I just so happen to have one right here in my back pocket.
You have the map of the Historical Society. Mm-hmm.
From the pizza place. Yeah.
We have the placemat from the pizza place.
Wow, he's so good talking to people.
No, she's out with Edison somewhere.
Yeah, they get fired.
Remember I sent them looking at the other houses?
Yeah, you're right. So
that's why I'm staying quiet. Which is
so not only is he good talking to people, he's good at getting rid of people. Mm.
So the mills are over here, and she draws a circle on the map. What you have to do is go around here. You're going to have to get this road. The only place to really park is over here, and you got a couple miles
good on spooky
to get in there. Like I said, he's out there tonight. Walk-in?
Is it an easy walk in? Is it like a trail or an old road?
It's more of a trail. You can find it. It's not like you wouldn't get lost, but it's not that easy going either.
Okay.
The first half of it's kind of open area, and then you trace through the woods for a while. You cut a corner, trace through the woods. I don't know, one of the old.
But it's marked. It's easy enough to find this. Find it at night.
Yeah, I mean it's supposed to be a full moon tonight, so you probably should be able to find or see at least out there.
Let me ask you about that full moon. You mentioned about the full moon. You think this is something to do with, you know, Bloody Jim?
I don't know. He always goes out there. He always thinks it's better on a full moon night. I don't know if it's because he can see better or he thinks something mystical is going to happen. Always see he can mystically pay off the credit card bill he keeps running up.
And he thinks he can find this hook that Jim was carrying? Is that the idea?
I don't know. I think he really hopes he's going to run into Jim and talk to him.
Do you think if he had this hook, he could talk to him?
How would he talk
like
to him? He's been dead 100 years.
Talk to the spirits? Like if he actually had the hook of Jim, Bloody Jim?
How would he talk to him? Bloody Jim is dead for 100 years.
I don't know.
Obviously,
I mean,
she's not
people say there's all sorts of weird.
Stay in touch.
Hey, I got a quick question for you. Just out of curiosity, where was he yesterday? Was he hunting yesterday, looking for Bloody Jim, Bob?
I don't know. He was. He went to work, and he came home. We had dinner with the kids. Put the kids to bed. Went for his usual evening stroll, came back, had a nightcap.
No way.
And then we went to bed.
What time did you... Oh, not there.
Between 5 p.m. and 7 a.m. in the morning. This is when the house was robbed.
I'm not there?
There's a huge window.
And he was right down the road from...
So anyway, he's in one of these sawmills. I don't know which one. There's 7 on the map.
Oh.
Okay.
Looks fine, his car.
Yeah, I mean, this is where he usually parks. I know that. Then he walks over. He said, that's the best place to park.
Well, I'm all for going in the middle of the woods in the middle of the night.
What time is it right now?
We just had dinner, so it's like between 5 and 6.
All right, do we run back to our rooms? Grab some gear? Hmm.
I think we make a quick swing by campus, grab some stuff, and head out over.
I like that
charge
idea.
Charge cell phones.
I'd say we wait until morning.
You obviously didn't watch Fear of the Walking Dead this week.
Nope.
Bob knows what I'm talking about.
I do.
If they left at night.
Andrew and I had a conversation about that. Can't talk about it now.
I would wait until the day, too. But anyway.
I agree.
100%.
Totally.
All right. We got to pick up some stuff before we... Gosh, you guys are sick bastards.
And at least the neighbor's face is so.
I need definitely to swing by campus and pick up some stuff.
We got to get some... If we're going
to
do this, guys,
we
got
to
go back.
Tell her I said thank you.
Well, we need flashlights and other stuff. I mean, we're going to be walking through a trail. We're going to need some way to get there.
We need some rope to tie to each other so we don't get lost.
I'm going to need a half hour to revise my timeline because now I have to expand another 8 hours that I can't see.
Hey, Edison, maybe you can do that in the car.
Well, maybe.
If you'd like, if you gave me some cards, I could quiz you.
Oh, all right, would you? I have to, well, I need 3 hours to make some cards, but then you can quiz me. Absolutely.
Just let me know what you need.
Thanks,
Rob. I'll be happy to give you anything you want.
That's really good. You happen to have like a statistical calculator like the T390? Because I've got a T80, but I'd rather have the T390. If you had a T390, that would be so helpful.
No, I got my solar-powered one that does addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and square roots.
She got it when she opened up a bank account.
So you have a T80? What is that from, like 1989? In high school, I had they were up to T85.
Yeah, I was going to say, wow, did we just date ourselves with the TI?
Mike, date ourselves? Did you not see the picture I sent out today?
No, I did. I was traveling
with
today.
General Lee on the flatbed getting towed by the A-team's van.
Oh my
All
god.
All that means is that somebody has as much money, as much disposable income as I want.
All I was looking for was Michael J. Fox with the DeLorean in the background.
Yeah.
That's been perfect.
You're hovering over it.
Money can't buy happiness, but it certainly is a great substitute.
Yes.
Yeah, you can't buy happiness, but you can rent it.
You can, exactly.
Yep.
All right, so we're going to head back to the campus then?
I think we have to. I think we need to get some stuff.
The list is life as a song.
Yeah, we're back to campus.
All right, so you head back to campus. You
guess I'll have to rent it.
All right, gear up. What do you got? What are you bringing? Within reason.
I'm just bringing my I'm just bringing my flashlight, my knife, my 357.
Fuzzy handcuffs.
Yeah, fuzzy handcuffs.
I will handcuffs he has.
We are getting better. Exactly. For like the past 3 or 4 sessions, Josh has given us the opportunity to gather equipment before we move someplace, and we're all like, I'm gonna get my cell phone and a flashlight. I'm good. No, I'm gonna get some sugar cookies and some saltine crackers maybe.
Hot pockets. I'm gonna hit up a hot pocket real quick.
I think a hot pocket would be really helpful for this adventure. In fact, I'm gonna pack 2, 1 for each pocket. Yes.
Yeah, you know, at some point we really should be smart and actually get some stuff.
But you're doing
one mode instead of bringing nothing. At least he's gonna bring a pocket knife now.
Yeah.
You bring out a case of MREs you have to give to everybody.
Wanlo doesn't know what an MRE is.
Wanlo can't spell MRE.
All right, Joe.
MRE? Oh,
what do you bring,
Joe?
MRE?
We have a flashlight.
All right, is it a little flashlight or is it a big, giant mag light?
Somewhere in the middle. It's an LED.
Okay. Nobody's bringing a lantern, though. You're all just bringing flashlights.
Who carries a fucking lantern to college?
You just spent enough time out camping that you might have bought one or acquired one.
No, that's true. Might have picked up one from Mexico.
So you're bringing your light?
Yeah, I packed, which is like a bedroll / pillow that I can sleep in. Not quite a sleeping bag.
Sure.
A little more rustic than that.
Sure.
A little more manly.
Yeah.
Some beef jerky.
Beef jerky. I got my
big water bottle.
Hammer / hatchet.
It's
a ham chip. A couple protein bars and some water.
Wanlo?
Wanlo will bring a pocket knife. I think he acquired one at some point. Yeah, a backpack.
Full of gold coins.
So yeah, some kind of bedding. I don't know what the hell he's got.
Are we sleeping?
Well, you never know. Did I say flashlight?
You just did.
Yeah.
Can I help you with?
Flashlight, pocket knife, and his trenching tool.
Is his trenching tool a little trouble?
Yeah.
Edison. Edison's bringing his books.
Edison is bringing SAS Enterprise Minor Guide and base SAS, including SAS Stat, which he will study for his 2 exams. On top of that, he's bringing Mechanical Engineering Principles 103 advanced classes, thanks to AP. He figures he'll just reread the book that night just to be safe. He's bringing his phone. He's bringing a flashlight. He's got a little time for a montage, like an AT montage where he uses MacGyver skill.
You need a montage. We're totally doing this to the montage song from Team America.
Guys, what should he invent? What contraption? Another set of Molotov cocktails? What's useful?
Why are you still at one? I have no idea.
Make your MacGyver roll. Give you what you got.
Smelling salts.
D6 and I guess it would be knowledge mechanical engineering. So D8.
You make half a pound of bath salt.
Six.
So he finds on your way back, you see that there was a party that let out last night. You grab the semi-empty sterno containers.
Hmm.
You create little sterno fireballs that you can.
That's great.
You encase them in something so that you can handle them for a few seconds after you light them and toss them.
Perfect. That's what he spends his time doing. And I don't know, is there a weapon? No weapon.
Slingshot. It's a slingshot that shoots
sternos.
Fantastic.
I'm awesome.
That is awesome.
I need to be a player.
Of course.
Mikey's thinking, how do I make that?
Edison can't hit the side.
I know that, though. I'm like,
somebody else.
Like,
is that shooting?
That'd be shooting.
You're bringing your books, your textbooks.
I already know mechanical
engineering and chemistry.
No, but one of us could know.
I'm bringing sex ed.
What if you get...
Chris is bringing condoms.
I'm bringing chemistry.
Oh my god, that reminds me of something my nephew said. I'll tell you guys all later. Though. All
right.
Does Ford Prefix have any knowledge of healing?
Oh.
13.
No.
Oh, and Ford Prefix, his smartness is a D8, did you say?
Yes.
If you give a surgery book to Ford Prefix, he instantly has a D8 knowledge of healing, which is like surgeon level.
For 18 seconds.
For 18 seconds.
I would think that you probably would be more inclined to give like a first aid book versus a surgeon book, because he's not going to remove an appendix in 18 seconds.
Huh? I could. Derek?
Michael, let's go.
Okay, so maybe a first aid book.
Somebody go slap her.
Oh, hey.
Hey.
Slap her on the back.
You need to know what I'm bringing, Josh. Are we good?
Yeah, I need you and Chris. You and Ford.
Okay. You ready? Go ahead,
Ford. You're right. Wait, go ahead, my ears.
I'm bringing my film canisters, Alka-Seltzer.
Okay. Go ahead, my.
You know.
All right. I'm pretty much after everything that I've seen at this point. I pretty much just leave my backpack already packed up. It's got my 357 bullets in it. I've got my flashlight in there.
Where'd you get a 357?
Water bottle. Huh?
Where'd you get a 357?
Mexico.
That wasn't the 357.
The people's house we were just at.
It was a smaller gun, but you have that gun. I think you still only have about 8 rounds for it. No, you bought more rounds. I just buy more rounds.
We bought more rounds for it, but 32? You said it was a 357. That's why I wrote it down.
Oh.
I don't remember being that, but okay. Not that it matters for the game. It's still 2d6.
Yeah.
It does, yeah, you could call it anything you want. It's 2d6. And I have another box of bullets, so I've got 57 bullets.
Sure.
But I don't need to bring all 57 of them with me. But anyway, it's got some power bars and snacks. It's got a water bottle, flashlight, my pocket knife. It's got a sleeping bag.
This is what it's
got. It's got my pepper spray in it.
Bang.
So... it's obviously got my extended battery phone charger. It also has my satellite phone, and I didn't have a satellite phone. Oh no. Damn. Okay.
Flint and steel, type of pole.
Okay, so far only Joe Diffie and Johnny would have brought water.
You guys brought water. Maybe I should bring some tools.
It's got a little mini first aid kit in it, and that's about it.
Okay, it's not quite cart time, but you're pretty heavy.
So.
Four.
Water. I'm going to bring my cleaver, my Molotov cocktail, big giant flashlight, and some rope. Might come in handy.
Okay.
Yeah, for tying ourselves together, absolutely.
Roxanne bows out for nighttime. She's afraid.
Oh, come on, Roxanne.
Really? Okay. Are you gonna keep me safe?
Nope.
Addison's better to take care of you than me.
It's getting pretty late.
Don't worry. I can calculate a algorithm that will definitely have you protected in my SAS stats class. You will ensure that you will get no grade lower than a B minus.
It's okay. I'm gonna come.
Great.
Can Edison hear what she just said to you?
Let me tell you. First, you have to learn the basics of a prop pole.
Okay, we can talk about it in the car.
You have to set a target there.
Let's talk about it in the car.
And perform
it. Just start.
Zero.
Car.
Eat a bit of catechol.
Anthony shows back up with the van.
What's Anthony at?
Anthony's got some legit video equipment now. Nice. Looks like it's got
night vision
stuff, yeah.
Nice.
He's got a backpack full. He's got a backpack because you don't know what's in it.
This is where they find the camera like a few years later, and they review it and they make a movie out of it.
There better not be any stick figures in the trees.
All you see
better not be any stick figures in the trees.
Yeah.
Piles of rocks.
I am so scared.
That's interesting. Sorry. This is actually a legitimate alert from work.
Cool.
Hey, it's all better. Sweet.
Is it something that you set up for yourself?
That's actually an outside monitoring service. We paid to monitor a bunch of stuff, and one of our RSFTP site went down, but now it's back.
Oh, God, thank God.
RSFTP?
Our work.
Oh,
Secure
SFTP.
SFTP.
Yeah.
Don't patch that.
It's bad when that breaks, because all his customers' orders don't come in.
Oh,
So, see, I have a lot of monitoring around the office I broke the other day. All right, so you guys are off. It is, I'm going to say it's about 8 now, 8:30. By the time you get there, it's 9:15. So you got a little catnap in the car if you want it.
Edison will use that time to study.
Juan Lo will catnap. Whether he's sleeping or not, his eyes are closed.
So it's like you at work.
Tomorrow.
All right, so you park off to the side of the road, and there's at least one other car there. You're guessing it's Ken Hart's.
Yeah, that's it.
Whoops, down again.
Nope. And there's a trail like she described. Apparently she had been out there with him once or twice before. So.
Anything unusual about the car?
No. I mean, it's windows up, it's locked.
Yeah, touch the hood. Is it warm, cold?
It's been there a while.
Yeah, use cold. The infrared to see if we sense any trace of hot.
No, I mean, the car, in the case of the infrared, the hood's cooled off, so you can't see the engine.
It's not the hood that I'm looking for. It's signs of any artifact.
No.
Okay.
Like whatever, if there was something that wasn't there long enough to leave a trace.
So okay. Nothing on the PK meter?
No.
Just a car. No other tire treads around?
Hard to tell. It's too dark.
Damn it.
I don't know. Daryl could track that kid in the dark. That kid with the...
It's because Daryl's the TV guy.
All right, let's kick on the infrared and I ask Anthony. Anthony, kick on the infrared. What do you see? What do you see? Night vision. What do you see around? Anything close?
Not much. She said there's a trail over there. I can make that out.
All right.
But Glenn Mack did provide you one pair of night vision goggles.
Nice.
Thanks, Glenn Mack.
What do you? Well, you stopped him to update him. He gave you a pair of night vision goggles.
That was wise of us. I'm glad we did that.
Oh, yeah. I was going to mention that. I totally forgot.
Yeah, yeah.
Or you texted him and told him what you were going to do, and he had them delivered. That's better. Because, I'm just being nice now.
That's like Peapod from Stop and Shop. Do you think we can... Hey, while we're here in this desolate location, can we call Peapod from Stop and Shop and order some groceries?
They can do it.
Can we... Like, I'm really...
You have no signal there.
In the mood for raspberries.
You have no signal there.
Oh, this is never get produce from Peapod.
Who's wearing the night vision?
Actually, everybody, the people I know who work there say get your produce from Peapod because they pick up before it goes on the floor.
Oh, wow.
That's so they actually get the fresh produce you get.
We order Peapod all the time.
Peapod would want you to think. That's like perfect Peapod.
But no, I actually have a guy who works at Plusco.
Yeah.
Plusco says the Peapod stuff gets picked in the back before it goes up.
Huh. By people who know produce.
We've had pretty good produce from them. Not great, but.
We order all the time. Although the grapes, they gave us like a single thing of grapes. You know when you usually buy.
Yeah, you want the big bag, they give you a little bag.
They give you a tiny bag. Yeah. But we buy everything on it. It's great.
It's funny. Like Peapod hasn't taken off. Now they're trying to do curbside pickup, and that's not taking off. People just want to go into the store. It's crazy.
No, if they don't, you can't order everything through that.
Okay.
Or we order a bag of grapes. We expect the bag of grapes. This baby get a bag. Yeah.
So it's sort of like Netflix. When you stream, you don't have access to all the titles.
Yeah.
You get mailed if you do. All
right, so you guys...
The broken Firefox that I got. I get everything.
Oh, you get everything.
You guys head up. You start walking through the woods.
What's our walking order?
That's the next question.
Oh, boy. Yeah, it's coming.
How about front? You can go 2 abreast.
Oh, I like that.
2 abreast except for Roxanne.
She's
and
got,
then 2 abreast.
She's already 2
abreast.
She's
breasts.
Got 4 abreast. She's already 2
abreast. She actually fits because you and Lon Lo are so skinny, she gets it next to either of you.
Oh,
so you take care of that, and I walk up front in the date with Johnny Moon.
Isn't he so brave walking up front like that?
No, he's like this all the time. He protects us all the time. He's such a good guy.
Anthony and I are in the back, I would imagine.
Are you? But you're taking it in the back? Okay, got it.
That's your guy. All
right, look at the vehicle that will be parked next to
us. So, Diffie, where are you? Somewhere in the middle or right behind Jeff and
Normally I'm up by Cochise, but I probably should be at the back, I think.
Okay.
Wait, wouldn't we want the guy with the gun and the night vision goggles to be in the front? Because I'm thinking.
Well, who has night vision? He took them?
I bet Diffie would.
I feel like the guy with the gun should have the ability to see things.
That makes sense. But the guy with the gun doesn't need to be up front.
Yeah, once the gun goes off, he won't be able to see anything.
What about the tracker? Should the tracker be have something on?
Oh, that's interesting.
I look at the car that was parked there, too.
Sure.
I look all around the driver's side to look at the imprints.
Sneakers.
Sneakers, okay. And that way I'll have a basis for tracking those.
Yeah, because we have some sites to check out.
Tracking. Good idea.
I will do my best to help you look for stuff to find him.
And I will walk behind
with
you.
With my tracking of negative two.
All right, so you head on out?
Yes.
And you have your marching order, and you are into the woods. It's like stepping into another world. You're 10 feet in. That full moon with all the bright gone.
It's like when Harry Potter steps into the hedge maze.
Yeah. And it's you hear the howls. You hear everything creaking and cracking.
And do we have a creepy but supposedly well-meaning professor hinting to us which direction to go?
Look up here.
No.
Drat.
Look up here.
It's supposed to be horror. You're not making it easy.
Oh.
We can't do horror with this group very well.
I have my flashlight in one hand and my...
What? Near the mirror?
Axe.
Oh.
Hammer axe.
Sure.
It was my axe hammer.
Yeah. It's like my hammer crash.
Hammer axe.
All right. So you're heading along. Hatchet.
Everybody's got their flashlights out, I'm assuming.
I don't have. I have my flashlight in my pocket.
There's
enough light from all you guys with your flashlights. On. I'm trying to preserve my night vision as best as possible.
Roxanne is like glue on Edison right now. She's terrified.
She has to help.
So is that?
She's squeezing your arm so hard you think that there's no blood flow left. Your left hand is numb.
That's not my arm.
Roxanne, I can't feel my arm. I think you're squeezing too hard.
But it's so scary down here. What was it? Coming? Help me.
And she's whimpering, and it sounds like she might as well be screaming at the top of her lungs.
It's okay. It's okay. Juan Lo and Joe Diffin, they're very good. I've seen them before. We fought these like weird dog-like creatures with long spikes, and you would not believe the way they fought.
But you only have six of those sterno balls. After that, you got the rocks.
Hmm. We're screwed up. I think you make a very impressive point. Guys, maybe we should come back.
During the day.
During the day, when it's less spooky.
You hear something fairly significant up ahead, and you see a man-sized thing race across the path, just barely at, you know, just at the edge of your sight.
Oh, Sasquatch.
I turn to Juan Lo, and I'm like, see, I told you Bigfoot was real.
What do you say?
I said I turned to Juan Lo, and I'm like, see, I told you Bigfoot was real.
Guys, did you guys see that?
I think so.
We can't, you know, ghosts aren't going to care. We can call out names, you know.
PK but, meter? Anything on the PK meter?
No.
Anything on the residual?
But if it's a mythical, you know, a Sasquatch or a chupacabra or any of that, it's still a mortal creature.
Yeah.
So that's not going to show anything.
No infrared heat signature from it?
Nobody told me they looked at the infrared.
Oh, I was just saying that a minute ago.
Too late. It went by fast. You all saw something at the edge of your vision.
So leaf footprints, heat prints.
Hey, Ken Hart, that you out there?
Ken.
There's a howl and another one runs behind you.
I pull my gun out. I have my gun in my hand now.
You catch a glimpse of something.
Oh, get that. Get it. Oh, she's just scratching post.
That's for that change. Looks like it's all clad in black with like a white stripe on it. Man size, maybe a little bigger.
It's a big skunk.
Pepe Le Pew. It's a man sized skunk.
Notice check monk. On the area around us to see if there's going to be a defensive position that we can move to.
Okay.
An area where there's a rock face or something like that. 10.
Ten. You
you realize there's nothing.
Or higher, right?
No. Johnny Moon gets you guys moving a little bit. He finds a spot where a couple of trees have fallen. There's kind of a spot where you can hole up maybe.
I tell everybody to shut all their flashlights off.
So we probably should.
They've got night vision, I'm sure.
Yes, but we don't. We are night vision shot with all these lights on.
No. We have night vision goggles. So turn all the flashlights off.
Roxanne's whimpering.
Give me the night vision goggles because I haven't had mine on. I have the best night vision so far, and we'll see what we can see.
Scared of whatever that is.
My bag.
Is it weird. Is it plastic?
No, it's fabric.
Oh.
It's just weird out.
Because plastic is very sweet to certain kinds of plastic.
You're touching sweet.
So, you're hearing the creature run around behind you.
Oh, it's a creature now. You gave it away.
Whatever it is. Being, creature.
Thing.
Thing. Roxanne is terrified beyond the capacity for rational thought.
She says it in those exact words.
Roxanne, it's a giant cheeseburger running by. Get it!
And,
get it, Roxanne!
And Anthony's like, every which, you know, turning the camera every which way.
Gentlemen, I think that you might need these soon. And Edison hands over the 6 sterno balls with the slingshot to Johnny Moon.
Is he quarterback?
He's a quarterback.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, he might be able to throw them.
Alternatively, if you shot it like a tree, it would provide flame for 10 minutes.
Gotcha.
Where the sterno splatter would provide some light. There's another howl. It's something big, or some things big. There's an answer to it.
Well,
are any of the trees climbable?
Not so much. They're pretty. There aren't branches.
They don't branch out until way high up. Yeah. It's a little forest.
Yes, it is.
Any long sticks that are around?
Sticks all over. You know, let's everybody give me a. How does fear? I want a fear check, but I don't know how the official.
Spirit, isn't it?
I don't know if it's spirit or smarts. I'm gonna give you a choice of either. Because I can see it going either way. You know, rationally, you can rationalize it. It's not fear.
Spirit or what?
Smarts.
Smarts?
Fear or smarts check?
Spirit or stamina? Spirit or, what was that? Spirit or
smarts?
Smarts.
11.
Giant Moon toughs it out.
Edison got an 8.
Edison's okay.
Oh, boy.
Anthony's holding his own. Anthony, 9. He wants the story.
There what you
was
go.
That?
4 for
Von Lo. Joe's got a 7.
You might want to save those when you take damage, Chris.
Roxanne, there's a funny spell in the air.
I have a plus 2 to fear test. 12. So.
Worse than normal?
Worse than normal.
Hey, the next one.
12.
I never use the damn things anyway. I'm going to flip out there today.
So,
Roxanne has soiled herself. Well, you know what? She's
Roxanne is absolutely just terrified. Beyond any, you know, it's like she might as well be a 10-year-old kid out there.
Hit a D8.
You know?
And I rolled a 5.
So.
On the D8. That, how does that come?
You rolled 13.
8 max.
8 and then a 5. Okay. I didn't see a roll.
So close. You feel invincible.
So I roll.
All right, so you're...
Get it, guys.
Excuse me.
Does anybody want to try to comfort Roxanne?
Nope.
No.
Too
busy being on the defensive, looking out for creatures.
Well, if you comfort her, you might fight her down. Because right now, everybody in the forest knows where you are.
Edison knows that his arm is getting crushed. He does his best to calm her because he knows his arm might not be crushed.
Yes, sir.
All right, so give me a... What skill would that be?
Persuasion?
Yeah, he's got a
D8
persuasion.
Yeah, let's use persuasion.
Edison has no persuasion skill.
Oh.
Okay, let's try something else. What else you got? Make me the case for something.
Taunter.
It's actually a versatile taunt.
Yeah, no, he can taunt.
Come on, you're not such a baby.
Mechanical engineering. Maybe he thinks he can soothe her by telling her all about the properties of
distract her.
Solid.
You know what? I'm going to say your taunt could be more of a jokey taunt sometimes. I'll let you use that as a skill to try to take her mind off.
Okay. Taunt? He has, believe it or not, I guess when I first made Edison, I put him at a D8 on taunt.
Because he has to learn it because he gets picked on so much.
Yeah, I guess so.
Yeah, I think that was it, yeah. He's like the guy who, like, when he's in the shower, he's constantly coming up with, like, every possible way he can be ridiculed and then ways to combat that, which only work really well in the shower. Whenever he does it, he fails critically.
It's like Stewie and his brother.
6.
That's, all right, so you managed to quiet her down.
Look, it could be worse. There could be vampires.
So you guys are silent for what seems like forever.
Eternity.
8 seconds go by.
It's like being in the car with Roxanne.
you're all there covered in a creature 8 feet tall, carrying a small tree trunk for a club. Walk slowly past where you are. All black, except for the little white around the face where there's some fur and a stripe down the back.
I thought we were just looking for a guy with a hook.
Did you get on the camera, Anthony?
I lean over to Cochise. Every man for himself.
Anthony turned the camera off so it wouldn't make any noise or have any light.
I just shipped
it. Safety first.
One time you shut your camera off. Damn it. Duh.
All right.
I'm far away.
I'm like, Johnny, we're faster than all these other guys. Let's go.
Safety.
Not if there's 10 of them.
Well, you only have to be faster than one of the other guys.
Yeah. Safety numbers right now.
We just have to walk.
That's right. We are all faster than Roxanne.
Wait a minute. Am I heroic?
Nope,
I run. Leave everybody behind.
All right, so you don't hear anything for a few minutes. You know, your hearts are racing. Your bodies are tense. You can feel the sweat already dripping down you as you try to stay cool, but you're just too...
Yeah, there's no staying cool.
Yeah.
We're amped up.
10 minutes go by with nothing except for the ambient noise.
Nice.
All right, guys, I think we can get one again.
Dude, anybody ever see Tomb Raider's Cradle of Life?
Yeah.
Nope.
Where the trees come alive, the creatures come out of the trees.
Dude, those are called Ents, and that's Lord of the Rings.
Yeah. No, it was in Tomb Raiders. Laura Croft.
I know what you're talking about. I have never seen it, or if I did, I don't remember it.
I've seen it, Mike.
Uh-oh, I
think Angelina Jolie and her dad, John Voight, are in that.
Yes.
Oh.
Yes.
Oh.
Yes.
But now they despise each other. Or she despises him.
All right. I'll wait for Jeff to get out of the bathroom.
Because he's our tracker.
She was my neighbor.
What?
Yeah, my brother was actually really good friends with her younger brother. He was always over their house.
Is that the one she was making out with?
No, no, no.
Oh. All right, so it's been 15 minutes since the last noise.
That one would have been really creepy because he was like 12 at the time.
The last thing you saw was the creature walking back toward where you had come from, so toward the vehicle.
Oh, good. So we don't have to run into the cab until we're trying to run for our lives and flee.
Well, we have to keep moving on.
How far have we headed in?
Maybe he's just getting off shift.
You're about a mile and a half, 2 miles into the forest.
Like Coyote and the Sheepdog.
So we're pretty far in.
You're pretty far in. You think you're halfway past. You're past the halfway point as far as getting to the
lodging camp.
Yeah.
How close did he walk by?
You to me.
So I go overlook the tracks.
They're big. It was like an 8 foot tall creature.
As though the thing had big
feet.
A big foot?
Yes. I'm going to say it's 16 inches long.
Just like my 16 inch ruler.
Just like your forearm.
Anthony, get video of the footprints.
I'm taking pictures too.
That's good.
We should cast a
little. So somebody put something in there for perspective.
I put my... Oh, no, wait.
I put a cell phone.
I unzip my pants.
Edison puts his foot in there.
That makes it look so much bigger.
Why, thank you.
All right, so you take some pictures.
No, I unzip my pants so I can get my gun out. That's what I was...
Oh. That's
guys, this is intense.
To a pair of pants.
I didn't know what I was signing out for this shit.
This is every day, Anthony.
You guys should have told me to bring spare underwear.
I know.
Just in case.
It's almost as exciting as taking an exam, right? I mean, you can feel the adrenaline rushing through.
This makes me want to go to a National Geographic
right?
all the time.
I know, but like, except with an exam, you know, at the end,
Edison,
you know that
Edison,
you're risking
inside
your academic
voice, inside
life.
Voice, Edison.
I mean, it's so much more intense, don't you think?
But Edison, you handled yourself very well. I was scared. I was shaking. But you, I looked at you, man, you had no problems with this whole thing. You are just cool as a cucumber.
Oh, thank you, Wanlo. It's because I follow your model. I just try to think to myself, what would Wanlo do right now?
WWWLD?
WWWLD, yes, exactly.
I just don't know which one of you two is braver.
Oh.
This time she goes back to Wallow for a few minutes.
I think Edison's pretty darn brave there.
Oh, thank you, Joe Diffie.
I agree with Joe Diffie.
Yeah, but I saw Wallow ready to spring out there. Oh.
I think what you saw was me cowering in fear.
No, I saw the look in your eyes. It was grim determination.
It looks something like this?
That was a nice deer in headlights look.
Actually, I was going with... it almost looked like the look that Vincini gives when they're doing the Princess Bride.
To the death?
To the death.
Oh.
Right.
That's a pretty good impersonation.
I've been working on that one.
That's a good one.
All right, so
one of my wife's favorite movies.
You hear the howl again. It's further off behind you.
Oh, he's slashing our tires.
Eating them.
Yeah.
I say we get moving down the trail towards the camp.
Right, so you head down the trail. I guess you get to a wet
quietly,
spot.
Quietly. Nobody talking.
Oh, is that where Roxanne was standing?
No. No, but there's a slightly swampier one area. Just
we're getting closer to the water.
Your shoes stuck down.
Is there any other tracks, coaches?
Any more 16-inch footprints?
Notice to see them. If you want to try to determine what they are, you'll need to track.
Nine.
With a nine, I'll let you get a plus one on your track roll. Yeah, there's different kinds of.
Three.
We got squirrels. Yeah. We've got field mice. We've got some raccoons over here.
There's some big animals and some small animals. And there's some and there's at least one pair of sneakers you think match the one from the car.
Let's head on in.
Keep on.
Is there a drier area to go to, or is it?
It clears up after a little while. Mm-hmm. It's kind of a 15-foot section of just where it got wetter.
Which way to the tracks point?
Bunch of different ways.
Which way do the shoes point?
I think they pointed towards the...
Down the trail.
Down the trail towards, the thicket.
All right, let's go down the trail.
All
right. And we walked on down the trail.
Josh, as we're walking down the trail, I'm looking for a good 6-7 foot long, sturdy stick.
Okay, most of what's fallen is dead stuff.
Christ, you flimmy son of a bitch.
So give me a notice check, Mikey.
Okay.
Only lefty, right?
I hate that.
Yeah.
No, I don't understand why. And then sometimes, have you ever noticed it switches nostrils?
Yes.
Yes.
Like in the middle of the night, all of a sudden.
Are you sleeping on one side and everything goes?
Well, you'll have 3 seconds of clarity.
I got 10.
And you'll be like, and then,
You find a sapling that you with a couple minutes of effort you'll be able to cut down.
Okay. Done.
Joe Diffie's with Johnny Moon's axe.
Yep, I give it a couple of whacks with Johnny Moon's axe, cut it down.
All right, so you have your Gandalf walking stick.
Got it. Start sharpening one end with my pocket knife.
Sure. All right.
You keep going.
You guys keep heading out.
We keep going.
Set your watch to his, nostril congestion.
Yes.
You
guys don't have that?
You notice that the trees get smaller. The trees seem to get smaller, younger. New growth.
Are they harvesting?
And you.
These trees are only 100 years old here.
And you step out. And you're finally. You see the first mill. It's a fairly good sized building. Fairly decrepit. It's 100 plus years old. And you can go inside. There's signs that people have been there. There's been parties. The kids like to party there because it's on the way place. So there's some old beer cans. Some garbage, some bags.
Ones with the old pull tabs with the triangular opening, that old?
If you want to go to that level of determining, we'll have to have a notice check. It is dark out.
I don't really care that much.
I know.
I would roll, but my phone is over there. And I'm over here.
That's far.
That's like...
Well, with your arm being 18 inches long.
Yeah.
I decided
having broad shoulders.
If I was a Jedi, I'd just be fat. Because I never get out.
Remote.
How are they not all fat? So. All right, so
you know what it is? Because they have to talk a lot. Most half the time when they talk, they have to be walking. Sometimes they're sitting in a circle. The rest of the time, they walk when they talk. Don't know where they're going, but they have to be walking.
I see. All right, so you found the first... it's probably about... midnightish, 11:30 midnight. You're all beat right now. I'm looking before you. It might be a place to hole up for the night. It might not be. You know, it's whatever you want to do.
Or we just go looking for
Tannehart.
Yeah, I think it's a good start point.
Yeah, maybe not. But I've got a plane to catch tomorrow.
Yeah, it's 11:30. It's almost 11:30. So.
Yeah.
That clock is 5 minutes off now, so it's 11:22.
All right, let's do a whole point.
Good.
You guys gonna set up? You gonna try to camp out in the sawmill?
Yeah.
PK meter and infrared. Is it glow? Is anything glowing?
No, no activity that you see.
Is there a room of some sort?
It's a one story building with like an attic spot.
Oh, okay.
You know, because obviously not gonna pull a log up to the top. Yeah, there's a lot. There's the saw at the bottom. You see the big giant 2 foot blade all rusted out. Most of the teeth have missed or thrown off. There's the old belt pulleys that are completely frayed out.
All right, we head upstairs, I would imagine. Barricade the door, sleeping shifts.
So you head up the creaky stairs. And, I mean, it's better cover than none.
Yeah.
You know, if it rains, you're gonna get wet, but you're not going to get soaked so bad.
And we'll be off the ground.
You'll be off the ground. The staircase, you're probably one or two at a time at most because you're afraid of, gonna give away.
Hey guys.
Roxanne goes last.
Yeah.
Hey guys, do you remember that giant skunk lab creature we saw that was 18 foot tall and all full of muscle?
Eight feet tall.
But it still had a very big foot.
Yeah.
No, actually, I don't remember seeing that, Edison. Where was that?
Well, the thing of it is, did you know what it was carrying? Did you notice that?
You mean that big giant like tree trunk that looked like a club?
Right, so here's what I'm wondering. What does that thing need a weapon to protect itself from? You know what I mean? Why does it need to walk around this forest with a weapon? That is what is really scary. What is it scared of?
Well, actually, with you around, Edison, I'm actually not scared of anything.
Oh, really?
I feel better with both of these boys. You've got, one on each arm. I feel so strong. I feel so safe between the two of you. I'm going to sleep right here with both of you.
Yeah,
I'm not going to let go all
Edison
night.
And Joe Diffie, right?
No.
Roxanne, it's too tight.
Okay, but don't run away from me again, because I can't take it. I
can't breathe.
She lets go. With it.
Or a little bit tighter.
Longer. Just make me pass out.
Juan Lowe rolls over, so his back is to
it. Oh, it's perfect. The Roxanne sandwich. Spoon me, Edison. And she spoons Juan Lowe.
As long as she doesn't say fork me, you're all right.
The rock sandwich.
Edison's in sleeping. He's lost time today, so he was studying for his mechanical engineering and computer science classes.
So you're getting more sleep than you planned on. So you should be up studying.
He's
the only thing I can say is if you guys eat for you like it, and you're going to be warm enough now.
Is anybody else staying up with him? Or?
Yeah, I'll stay up with him.
You going to take shifts?
Yeah.
All right, if you two are staying up, then I'm going to grab some rest right now.
Edison's not taking shift. He's staying up all night.
And I'll take the night goggles.
Yes.
All right, so Edison is up, and then one of the person takes turns with the goggles.
Yeah, we'll rotate that other person.
Yeah, it's like an hour for each of you.
Sounds good.
Edison is going to have to take a mirror check next session, though, to see if he's negative 50.
He's going to fail. Here, we'll get it out of the way now.
No, we'll make it tomorrow, next week.
Next week.
No, well, let's get it out of the way now while it spells all these bennies.
That's right.
But we're not there yet.
Mm. We're not there yet. So it's true.
All right, so as the night wears on.
We try to close the doors down there.
Yeah, there's no doors down there, but there's a door for you. You can see through the floor of our dirt. You know, it wasn't built well.
They had all this wood that they could have. Oh wait.
So, was trying to sell.
We think 1, 2, 3.
Oh boy.
Johnny Moon. During your later watch, while Edison is busy nosing book. Half awake, half asleep. You up and look outside, and you would swear you see a man carrying his own head in a hook in the other hand.
Dun, dun, dun.
How do you get a little hit? You fall into a song.
And that's how we're going to end.
Ooh. How did the lumberjack lose his head breaking leaves? He fell out of the tree.
I had a feeling that was where I was going, but...
Why did the lumberjack cross the road? To cut the tree on the other side. How many lumberjacks does it take to screw in a light bulb? None. There ain't no light bulbs in the forest.
I think you should be studying.
Yeah, it's yeah.
So we know what happens to Edison when he gets tired.
Yeah, he gets a little loopy. Yeah.
All right, I'm going to stop. This was session 9, I believe.
Session 9, wow. Oh, okay.